Hey guys, welcome back to the Hectic Podcast. We're on every single podcast platform, including Spotify, Apple, and Google. And if you also want to watch the uncut video, tune into YouTube. We appreciate you listening in and enjoy this episode.
You know, see behind the curtain over here, and this is just
pay no attention.
Wizard of Oz style here.
Yeah, it's magical over there.
And that literally looks like it could almost be hot cocoa, like with that head on the top.
Maybe it is.
It's lovely. The window is open.
What's up?
It's the best
just
kind of
button
cocoa.
On top or button on the side. Take your pick. Dealer's choice.
Up, up, oh.
There you go.
Four cameras can you get in this thing?
Is that one rolling?
Yeah, thing.
Start the big guy? I don't know.
Oh, yeah, it's rolling.
Cool beans.
Is it more better?
It is more better.
Mo better.
Mo better.
Means that Quentin's got to stay up later editing. Other than that,
so oh, yeah, I actually have to edit it all tonight because
what?
I have to go pick up Logan tomorrow.
Oh, wait, she's driving back with you?
Done. She's coming back to drive with me, yeah.
And you think you're going to play video games tonight?
I'll definitely play video games tonight.
It doesn't sound like you're going to be able to squeeze that in.
These two girls got me hooked on video games.
Okay, so this is...
I try to play Call of Duty at home sometimes.
Yeah, my bad. Yeah.
So
I've been hooked lately.
Quentin's entire YouTube career is going to be derailed by his newfound obsession with Fortnite.
Fortnite no builds. Don't get it mistaken.
Wait, do we play a difference?
Yeah,
it's a whole different game.
I'm sorry.
We did say, like, we're going to be so out of touch with us.
Absolutely.
I got the Mr. Beast reference, and that's going to be it.
Yep. We're done after that. That's our one
Who's
for the night. The one from combined
four.
Between us.
Yeah.
We're four. Yeah, but now I'm a gamer, so that's how I am now.
Twitch starting Tuesday.
Yeah. Tristan's been saying
jointly.
So for 3 months now, Tristan's been saying how he's going to stream and like get shit done, and he hasn't bought a damn thing.
Bought?
Okay.
Bottom
focus,
paid for.
Focus on what we're focusing on.
We're not we're supposed to be roasting me right
shit
now.
Shit on the right person.
Right.
I'm so sorry. I gotta understand the rules.
You ain't bought nothing.
So we have about, I think about 15 to 20 people who come back every week and listen. So I always like to say hello to those people.
Yeah.
If they continue to listen.
Are you running us down like the show notes here of what we're gonna do?
I don't know. I'm kind of just freeballing here.
Fair enough.
Yeah.
I'm just waiting for you to like be in the middle of freeballing and then hit start.
Yeah.
Without telling you.
Eventually,
It started.
Oh, yeah, that happened.
Yeah. I try to get a nice smooth rolling. Yeah.
Come on,
now
Grandpa.
Everybody knows.
Yes. Okay.
But for those who are listening and watching, I have, well, my boss is here, actually.
Ooh.
So.
Who's that?
That's you, buddy.
Oh,
that's you guys.
Like, oh, your boss is listening?
Paul and Shelby are with us.
Ooh.
And they're going to join us for the night before I leave Wisconsin, sadly. So we are going to ask them a bunch of questions. And apparently Shelby has questions for us, too, because she did her homework. So
overly prepared.
Yeah. Right. I actually did want to open up because I actually haven't asked you this, but where did you go for C? Don't get mad that it's a King's Point question, Tristan.
I'm not going to get triggered from that.
Where did you go?
Does Tristan get butthurt about these questions?
No, not at all. I just
it's
refer
a cult.
To it as a cult.
Because I always bring it up.
He just pulls out his phone and kind of detaches.
Yes.
Yeah. Like, I'm just going to sit here for a while.
He even like interjected one of his cult buddies into my friend group, who got Allie.
Oh,
so,
yeah.
Like,
oh, yeah.
And we had a King's Point girl thrown in there. I'm like, man.
It happens.
No, it's good. It's good.
But where did you go?
Back to the question at hand. So first sailing I went to Northern Europe, so Belgium, England, Germany, and then second sailing I went to Colombia, Uruguay, Brazil, Trinidad, South Africa, Gabon, Cape Verde, Canary Islands, Houston, that doesn't really count, but Houston,
some people
I guess.
Been in Houston, man. That's a good time down there.
Yeah, and then throw Hawaii into the mix, I guess.
Yeah.
So that was...
That's a good one. What was your favorite?
So the second ship I was on for 150 days straight, and that was a blast.
Oh, yeah?
It was kind of a nightmare at the time, but it was a lot of fun because we
stayed...
Oh,
you're not kidding. You're being serious.
No, I'm absolutely serious. Like, because we stayed in port like 3-4 days at a pop.
Oh, I see.
Yeah, it wasn't just like a quick turnaround every time.
Okay.
So
I can see how that...
That made it really fun.
Right.
We got really drunk.
Right.
So...
And you married a girl that had literally been to 4 states before.
Yep. And then we fixed that real fast.
So how many now? How many is it now?
Oh, I think I have 10 to go.
Yeah.
But, okay, here's
I only have one to go. She has 10.
No. Here's my grand plan. Because I'm not competitive
sure.
at all. The grand plan is he's missing Rhode Island. So we're just going to go to the other 9 that I'm missing. And then we're going to hit Rhode Island at the same time. And then also, he technically hasn't been to all 7 continents because you didn't step foot off the boat. in Australia. So we're going to go to all the other ones.
So
that's actually really cool.
The lesson learned from this is that Shelby is the most competitive person in the world.
I see that.
Reasonably competitive.
Please tell me that's Miguel.
It is Miguel.
Okay.
She's devising.
Some random dude that walked in.
This place looks open.
No, I will say that's one area that I'm always a little envious when you guys start talking about your cult is
it's a good cult.
Is all the pins in the map as There's a result
quite a
of
few,
that.
Yeah.
It's cool stuff.
We totaled up countries at one point, but I don't remember what the number was anymore.
Yeah, I know. It was enough to make me sick. I was like, I've been to
at one point
four.
We like took the time to actually like list them out and everything? I was like, I had them all, but I couldn't tell you how many it was now. I don't remember.
You had to do it for your security clearance.
Oh, that's right.
Yeah, and it was
Oh, it was a nightmare. Because it's like, oh, list all the foreign countries you've been to in the last 7 years.
And I'm
like,
dates.
Oh my gosh.
Like, it was like general dates too.
I was like, okay.
Was that for TMMG?
Security
clearance?
Yeah.
If that doesn't set off it? Yeah, I think I had to renew it.
Yeah, it was.
Yeah, whatever it was. It came due. But it definitely sets off some alarms.
Yeah, a couple red flags.
Yeah. And it's like, so why were you here for only 3 days? So like, well.
I dropped off that package.
Yeah.
And then
I left. And it was great. And then you went to this other really sketchy place along the way. It's like, well, even better.
Yeah.
Great.
Tristan, where do you want to go, man?
Dude, I need to see everything and anything I can, honestly.
Everything,
I've never even left the country.
Never left the country before.
That's not even Canada?
No.
Oh, man. I feel like we're so close.
It's like our hat. I mean, I've been thinking more a lot lately, but they've been having bans for, like, people that don't have their vaccine.
Oh.
I'm one of those naughty fellows who doesn't have it. So.
Listen, we had a nightmare time coming back down from Alaska, like, into Canada, because those restrictions were
We, like, snuck through a window where we could, like, where they opened up and we could go. I'm like... Thank goodness we did, because it got shut down like a month later.
Like a literal window?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Like, and through, like through the open window? No, yeah. Exactly.
Okay.
That's how you get bear.
Yeah. For sure. Yeah.
Sneak right in.
But like literally, I mean, crossing the border was like so insane. They tell you the Canadians are just like the nicest people. And like, I don't know how many Canadians you have watching the show. But like,
we had
the singular mean Canadian as the border agent. It, like, it was awful.
She was a witch.
Yeah. Really? We got like.
in true like physical form.
We were like turned away. We broke down in Dease Lake, Canada, which like terrible. Had less people in their town than like I went to high school with, which is like saying something.
Yeah.
Like it was terrible. Yeah, we like broke down probably, for like 4 days. She's probably your number
probably
one viewer.
That'd be hilarious.
Yeah, she's like, these motherfuckers.
Yeah, I remember you.
I remember you pulling it at midnight at the hotel with your wheel wobbling off. Oh, great.
She's probably known Canada wide for being the one rude person.
She gets
Canada.
The award every year.
She's sitting at home right now watching, like, I left an impression. I'm here for
lasting legacy.
Everybody thinks these Canadians are nice. We're trying to keep these damn Yankees out of here.
Oh my gosh.
Keep them going.
Let's go home.
You gave a cop-out answer. If you could go anywhere right now, country-wise, where would you go? With
Ooh,
your knowledge that you have.
Oh, like, to live there,
you're
saying?
Like, I want to go everywhere.
No,
like,
just
for,
like
a vacation.
To go and experience
vacation.
And travel.
Oh, give me vacation.
I'm going to have to go with Iceland.
Ooh. Oh, right. See, there you go. Yeah,
that's a typical white boy answer.
That's
I'm
probably
not going to lie.
Very inexperienced traveler.
I've been there, all right?
He struck me as more of an Amsterdam guy.
Oh, okay, there you go.
All right.
I can see that, too. Yeah, for sure.
But with all the places you guys have been, what made you guys okay with staying in Wisconsin?
That is the $1 million question.
That is.
Was it $1 million?
No. Nope.
It was not.
How much you got to eat?
No, it was not the $1 million answer. Let's put it that way. You want to answer this one?
You can answer it after I say, literally, Wisconsin was the only state that I swore that I would not move. Like, we, for all the states that we went to, and we were like pretty early on in the trip too. Like, we, for people that like, I have no idea who we are. We lived out of our truck and then like a teeny tiny like sliding camper that like popped up for like a year and a half. And we like traveled all around. But anyway, so we like left Virginia and then drove up to Michigan, drove across the Mackinac Bridge. And then like we started driving down through Wisconsin and the roads were so shitty. Like, they were literally so terrible.
Well,
and
to be fair, they're the same condition they are now.
Wait, this is the Wisconsin side?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
So
okay.
It was, like, between here and
Paul
Green
said
Bay.
We drove through Verdun. I don't remember
We drove across the bridge and through town.
But
really?
So, literally, the roads were so bad. Like, after we got past Green Bay, I was like, we're taking back roads. Like, the truck is going to snap in half. This is a bullshit state. Yeah. I don't even want to be. I will never live in this state. Yep. And then I was so mad that I was like, I'm not even camping here. We're going to drive all the way to Minnesota and we're going to camp there. And then we had to drive back across to Wisconsin to get breakfast. But I was like, I don't even care.
It was like, weird flex against Wisconsin at the time.
Yeah,
disrespectful. Like, I'm eating pancakes here, but I need to sleep here.
Exactly. It was
I slept over there.
But the way the weight is in the truck and the way the roads have like those seams going across, the whole thing was just like a bucking Bronco the whole way down.
How long
the road.
Ago did you make that drive?
Two years. 2 years ago,
So when they first redid that highway between here and Green Bay, it's gotten a little bit better, but I had a car and I had brand new tires at the time. And coming back from I think it was a Packer game, it was just bouncing back and forth. It was like, all right, we're on rails now. Wherever this road wants me to go, that's where we're going.
And we were just, something about it, we were just bucking. And you could watch we could watch the bumper just like shaking in the front. And I was like, something's not good here. Something's not going to end well.
Shouldn't be having just massive cavitation on the highway.
Vehicle cavitation is probably another good thing.
On your cross-country journey, how many times did that thing break down?
Once
in Canada, broken. Really? I fixed it in Alaska. Once we got to Juneau, I fixed it at our buddy's place.
Did you carry it on your shoulder to Alaska?
No. Like, we got it good enough.
We got it like temp fixed in Canada, got where we were going, and then I fixed it for real.
Okay.
Until it wasn't.
Well, then we had a separate issue with the rear end that we had to get replaced.
So Paul's at sea. He's in Greece. Yeah. Decides to stay a little bit longer at, they're doing a ship check. So
we had the shipyard period. That I had to stay for because my relief quit on me.
And then a
terrible.
Oh yeah, that ship thing. Terrible. Ship things happen, and he was like, "I think I'm going to stay for this." And I was like, "Okay, but like I'm in Alaska by myself, and I don't know what's going on with the truck." And then, oh man, I was in Anchorage, camping in.
A neighborhood.
A neighborhood.
Someone's backyard.
And then, you talked about this once public before. Yeah. I'm like so derailed right now. But you talked about this on the podcast once before about like Walmart parking lot staying.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Dude, she's done her research, man. She has done her research. She went all the way back to the beginning.
Yeah, that's way back.
Wow.
Yeah. I don't know if you were prepared for this type of acumen.
I wasn't.
You gotta be.
She's more prepared than I am.
Best Walmart parking lot stay ever was Bozeman, Montana. Literally, I just was like, I could live here in row F.
We rolled up like fairly close to sunset and we're like, I don't need to go check anywhere else. We're just going to stay here.
Yeah, no.
Just because it's sunset.
Well, no, you're looking at Walmart from like a little bit of a hill in the parking lot.
Always
and a right fantastic view.
Let me describe it to you.
And right behind it is Walmart. This massive, glorious view of mountain range.
Yeah.
And we're just looking at the sky and we're looking at like nice blue sky, but we're just like, This is the best Walmart parking.
Yeah, we didn't feel like driving any further and Walmart was. Anyway, totally derailed there. I'm in Alaska. Paul's stuck in Greece and the electricity goes out in the camper.
Yep.
And I like checked everything. Yeah, but it's like October. So it's like getting kind of chilly.
Getting cold.
Yeah.
And then the heater didn't work, right?
Yeah, so the heater didn't work. And then I was like sleeping in like Gander Mountain parking lots and neighborhoods. So that was real sketch. and we don't have like a toilet or a shower. So you have to like... hold
everything.
You got hold it until Gander Mountain opens at like 10 o'clock in the morning.
Everything is the right word for that.
Miserable. Oh, it's awful.
Especially in the neighborhood.
Yeah. Well, and then the truck started making weird noises, so I couldn't camp any further out of town. So thankfully, these three random girls who I met I met through Paul's mother-in-law.
Yep.
And
no, my mother, your mother-in-law. Let's get this right. So
touche. Anyway, she like hooked me up.
You're gonna tell a story, get it right. That's all I'm saying. It's a weird way to.
I know.
That's a weird name to call your mom.
Anyway, I like slept on their couch for like 2.5 months while you were at sea, while the truck was broken in Alaska, and it was. I've never felt more like I was doing my. Late 20s wrong.
wait, does questioning your family life. Live in Alaska?
No. So my mom is friends with a lady at her church, and this was her daughter who was living in Alaska.
Her like 21-year-old daughter.
No, because as soon as my mom found out, my mom literally emails me on the ship, and she said, "You need to call me now."
Oh God!
Oh gosh, what happened?
Heart sinks. What's going on?
And she calls me. I call her. She goes, "I don't know what you're doing with your wife, but you got to take care of her."
Holy shit!
What are you referring to? And she goes, she's out there all alone and people are banging on the side of the camper.
Oh, yeah,
she's
that,
unsafe.
That literally was scary.
She's unsafe and you need to do something about this. I said, Mom, I am in Greece. I am across the other side of the world right now. What would you like me to do? She's told me that everything is fine. She can handle it. What do you want me to do?
Right.
So it's like, if you want to do something to drive up
there,
by all means, go ahead. But I don't know what I could do in this situation. Right. Like, she's a big girl. She can handle herself. Yeah. No problem. If there's an issue, I'm sure she'll figure it out.
But anyway,
find someone who can help her.
Other than those two times, the truck didn't break down at all.
That's pretty impressive.
Yeah. She's a good, we call her Shamu. She's a good steed. Trusty steed.
And the camper's name is Fife.
Yeah.
So Shamu and Fife.
Yeah.
Yep.
Fife? So, am I saying that right?
Yeah. Fife. Okay. Not that we're old enough to remember.
Yeah.
But do you know the Andy Griffith Show?
I've heard
the Andy Griffith Show. So Barney Fife.
You know it's black and white.
Derail this too much, but we spent,
by all means, derail.
We spent 90 minutes, maybe more, one afternoon in the office explaining to Quentin the idea of dial-up and a landline phone.
You've never experienced that, too?
Dude, you're like 1 year old.
Oh, dude, I had that shit.
You literally tried to claim you're a millennial.
Yeah, exactly. I live in a tiny ass town.
I can sing it for you, the dial-up. My parents don't even have internet now.
Yeah, like, I didn't until I went to college. So I spent 18 years. I had the dial-up until I was like 16.
Longer than me.
Yeah. I forget what happened. Something wasn't working on the internet. I made the comment about you need to hang up your phone. And he's like...
You're like a generation younger.
I think so.
Do not speak up like you're in this generation. You are 1 year older than me.
Hold on. Did you see the collective motion there?
I saw that.
Okay. I take that back.
And I'm curious where you draw this line.
I want to draw it when I need to draw it.
Because I'm 1 year younger than you, or
I'm like a year older than Tristan.
Ah, fuck. Look, I knew.
Oh no, am I gonna get like wrinkles?
We're old here.
I think we might be the oldest people for this podcast.
That's
I
not
knew
good.
What dial-up was.
Evacuate.
I know.
It's okay. It's okay.
I knew what dial-up was. I don't know. I just never had a phone or any internet growing up, so I didn't know like how the fuck that worked.
I remember trying to order soccer cleats on a dial-up connection. Oh my lord.
That sounds interesting.
I remember like sneaking.
And then I had to return them because unfortunately my dad told me to order the size of ordering a monstrous size at the time. So it was like a size 14 or whatever it was. I was in high school.
Right.
And of course, what shows up?
Not a
kid's size.
A youth.
14.
Oh.
Ballpen had that one.
Very necessary.
Yikes.
I remember trying to sneak over to our family like computer room, which was in the laundry room, and then you'd like forget that the speaker volume would be up, so you'd like go to click on dial up, and all of a sudden it'd be like, dude, like just like so loud.
I've decided
just a chat on AIM.
So you hit on something interesting there. The term computer room.
Oh,
is there a designated room?
Yes, I had that.
The size necessary to fill a room.
Yeah,
my computer room is my pocket.
Yeah.
Well, not only was it a room, it had racks of things called CDs.
Ooh, we got
floppy disks.
Yeah, believe it or not,
I asked him if he knew what the save icon was.
Oh, yeah, even better.
It did?
Not a chance.
I would have known that if you would have I didn't put two and two together because I used the same every day.
Well, so see the other thing that lived in the computer room was like four old monitors on the floor.
Oh,
every
yeah.
time, right?
Yeah.
So you had to have a whole room. It was a storage locker.
Of course.
The massive corner desk with the CD rack built in. And a printer.
Mm-hmm.
And the Rubbermaid totes full of like VHSs. Because they were like the perfect height. Yeah. You could stack all of them so you could see the spine.
That's what I had way more of. Because I didn't have internet or a home phone. But we had.
Did you walk up the hill?
Thousands.
Up to school, uphill both ways, barefoot in the snow?
That's absolutely what happened.
Yes. I don't know what that means. I'm just going to say. Yes.
This became an age conversation very quickly.
It became very fucking quickly. That's like I'm the one at the wrong side.
Wait, no, Paul and I were talking about this though. So you and Logan have literally been together.
That's a great segue to the question that you have ready.
Double the amount of time that Paul and I have been together.
What you waiting on, bro?
We were really young.
No.
Easy now,
good
player.
Good question.
But I was going
to
ask you, what do you think you and Logan could teach Paul and I about being in a relationship?
No, that's my question to you, too.
Oh, there it is. Turns it around.
I don't know. I really don't know. That's a hard. Damn. What the fuck, Shelby?
I love that. He needs to be humbled every once in a while. Yeah.
There's no more fun moments on this podcast than when Quentin gets thrown
just
off.
Stymied.
I love it. See, this is when the fun starts.
Yeah, he's running it over there. He's doing his Mr. Beast thing, and then all of a sudden, just derail his flow. It's my favorite part.
Love it.
No, man.
So, Quentin, with you also leaving Wisconsin here in a little bit, tell me the advantages and disadvantages of moving to Wisconsin for six months.
What, write a fucking term paper? What's going on?
I don't know.
If you could persuade me in 5,000 words.
Persuade me to stay.
And I didn't move to Wisconsin, all right?
You basically did.
You've been here for 7 months, bro.
Yeah, that's a long ass time.
6 months?
Don't believe it.
I'll give you that.
You've basically been living here.
If you could compare and contrast between Charleston and Marinette, the pros and cons of each.
Okay, now we can start.
You've been here long.
Give me some Wisconsin.
Give me some Five Whys, you know.
Sun?
W, I don't know.
Actually, that's all I got. Sun.
7 months.
My house.
Here.
My house.
Your answer.
There.
Well, that's
the biggest thing.
That's
something.
But your house is movable, so I mean.
Well,
not the house itself, but I mean, you know what I mean.
The house isn't movable, but a home.
That's
is movable.
That's what I was getting at. Too literal.
But everybody makes fun of me in sock one, or where in the building that I'm in, because they're like, you really have the easiest job. How do you, like, why is this? And I'm like, it's because I don't go home every night. Like, if I could go home every night, I could do this fucking forever. You know what I mean? Like, Jen was giving me shit today about how, it's like, yeah, but you, I'm so, like, jealous. Like, you know, you don't do anything, which kind of hurt a little bit. But, yeah. Because I'm sitting there grinding this fucking aluminum.
A couple daggers to the heart real
quick. Yeah, like, yeah. But I kind of got it. I kind of get it because, like, Jen and Mike do much stuff.
But no, you asked us earlier, like, why we moved here. Like, that's why we moved here. Like, I didn't want to move to Wisconsin, but Paul had the opportunity to, like, be home full time, which we had never had. Like, right. 3 months ago, we hit the longest stretch that we'd ever consecutively been together. Like, really? I don't. Yeah. Like,
how long was it?
I don't know. We added
like
up
4 months.
Added up all the time that we had actually spent together before we got married, and it was like less than a year. Like
say,
physically,
that's
in the same
how we are.
And,
it was.
I know this kid took a risk.
Yeah,
sure did. Paid off too.
Yeah.
All right.
Did you guys get any extra arguments after being together for four months straight?
Did you learn anything new about each other?
So after being in a very small space in a camper for however long?
You
guys are all just cracking up here. Okay, good.
No, not you. It's Tristan.
Tristan putting on a serious hat over
like
there.
I like it.
This and that. Yeah.
So sidebar, but leading into your answer to your question. So when we first set off on the trip, my cousins came up to Virginia from North Carolina. And he took one look at the camper and he said, "Oh, you've created the marriage Instapot."
Yeah, that's
I said, "What do you mean?" He goes, "Oh, well, you're just gonna throw a brand new marriage into that tiny little thing, pressurize it, and then see what comes out on the other side, and hope it tastes good." And we're like, "Well, yeah,
tastes
kind of right."
Here we are.
What's wrong, Quentin? You're running around like a turkey
camera,
here.
Camera time's out. He's got to go reset it.
Yeah, you would know if you listened to the podcast, Paul.
You've listened to it. Before I came on the first time, I jumped in at what? Like episode 10?
Well, let me
I'm
tell
sure
you.
Shelby can tell you which episode you jumped in on.
Yeah, honestly, it was like episode 10 was my first. Like, watching around maybe 35 minutes of it just to kind of get a feel for what I was walking into.
Valid.
And I think all I knew at that point was Kratom. And And I think that
Mr.
was
Beast.
It.
That's all you
needed.
That's all you know.
That's all I needed to know.
Yes.
You pretty much had the cliff notes at that point.
Yeah, like, you know, Joe Rogan has DMT.
Yeah, exactly.
The Hectic Podcast has Kratom. Pretty much what it is.
Eventually, it'll morph into something nice. Okay. Eventually.
Just like Joe Rogan,
It's like little bit at a time. Yeah. Just, you know, make it into something.
Right.
Did I give you enough time to think about?
No.
Okay.
No.
I was going to say, we've got some unanswered questions right now.
I don't know. I just feel like what you guys have done the same thing. You know what I mean? Like,
what do you mean?
On and off, where you do long distance. You know, so it's kind of like there's not much I can tell you that you don't already know.
I mean, that's fair.
You know what I mean?
Sounds
like a cop out answer.
It is a cop out answer. Thank you, Paul.
Okay, so on one of the episodes I listened to though, Logan talks about like wanting to be like a little event coordinator thing. Okay.
Yeah.
So I have the best idea for you guys, and then you'll never have to part again.
Okay.
You guys need to work on a cruise ship And yeah. she can be like the event person, and you can just work in the engine, and then you guys can still sleep in the same bed. And
we've
then,
talked about that, but
we've literally talked
would,
about doing the same thing.
Yeah,
before.
We talked
they
about
let that happen. We talked about that on yachts too.
I'm sure they yeah. would. Yeah.
But how does she? Like,
that
I don't understand
it, it
how I
have,
get in the job.
They have one less room they have to fill.
True, that's how I market it.
Yeah.
Like yo, you can get another
two
crew member if you let us stay in the same room.
True,
done. Perfect.
True. But how would so like I know how I would get the job, but how would she get the job?
I thought you told
apply
me.
Apply like anyone else?
Well, yeah, that too.
Yeah, so the internet.
So there's
what's
this thing
that?
Called dial-up.
Yeah. Oh, right.
Yeah, start at the beginning.
The worldwide
Alan
web.
Turing.
That's just pure disappointment.
What the fuck is Alan Turing?
The Imitation Game?
That's a great movie too.
Pioneer of the modern computer.
Yeah.
Or not the modern computer.
Well,
the beginnings of computers.
The building blocks of the computer.
Nope.
Yeah.
Nope. Dude.
And this, so what
step
I
step up your game. Your
really,
Imitation Game.
Yeah. Yeah. What
here's
really
homework.
Gets
I'll
me.
Watch tonight. We'll see what we can.
What really gets me about him with that is it's not an age thing. It's the fact that he has made the internet a cornerstone of his existence.
The internet in 2020.
And see, that's
not
the thing.
1999 internet.
I guess I'm curious. How do you do as much as you do
without a little Google
without,
search every
without
now
going
and
back
then?
To the, you know, back to the beginning.
Because it's history.
To the roots, man.
Don't give a fuck about it.
Oh,
interesting.
That's an aggressive stance to take.
I'll rebuttal that. Because when's the last time you used a film camera? That's how cameras are made. When's the last time you
yeah,
picked up a film
I'm
camera?
I'm aware of them.
There's a difference between using.
I'm aware of.
Okay, but you couldn't.
Alan
you
Turing?
Can't use Alan Turing's computer.
No.
Someone tell me who this man is.
I'm not asking you to have dial up in your home. I'm just asking you to know what it is.
Right. Would you like me to get dial up?
No.
No.
That's not what we're asking.
Absolutely not. I wouldn't wish that on.
Yeah.
Fine. I'll get dial up.
My own worst enemy.
Fine.
Right.
I'll get it.
We
fine.
Suffered so
those
that the next generations
sounds.
Don't have to.
Right. Right.
So I've heard Brock's imitations on here. I need to hear an imitation of the dial-up network connection.
No, it's not that level of thing.
Wait, you did it. Wait,
what did I do? I did Alex Jones once. That was it.
No, that's fair.
It's about it.
I heard an Australian accent at one point.
Yeah, we
you're pretty good. And he's got a radio voice. Man, he just let's just fucking change it to the broccoli podcast.
No, you're just trying to broccoli. Deflect. You're just broccoli. Trying to deflect.
Yeah, my favorite thing
Wait,
is when
I
can work in
again?
Some ads.
He
loves that.
What?
Yeah, you're pretty fired up.
No.
Yeah.
No, we're not doing any ads. Brock's too seamless with it. I don't know when the hell it happens.
Gosh.
I just turn around, it's there.
Wait, so how did this trio happen? Like, do you work in the same sock as they work?
He moved up into the office I'm in.
Oh.
And I think
he
I think
started I, in the office Tristan was in.
Yeah, I think I caught him browsing cameras at one point or browsing something, and I was able to do a lot of I have that. Don't buy that.
Okay.
Because I have a collection of equipment. And
that'll do her.
Yeah. No.
Now here we are.
I was invited on, I think, as a one-time guest, and then I refused to leave. So yeah. That's kind of where we are.
Well, I mean.
I use them for an equipment.
There's a level
mutually
of
beneficial
involved
then.
There, right?
Yeah.
Right.
Squatting, squatter's rights?
Yeah.
Is that your chair now? Do you own the chair spot?
Yeah.
Is that thing?
Yeah. And so, I don't know.
Your chair?
I don't own anything. I'm going to show up here 2 weeks from now because I won't be here next week, but I'm going to show up 2 weeks from now, knock on the door, be like, all right.
Podcast.
Yeah,
it's podcast.
We're
going to
start
recording.
We'll leave it open.
That could be a good segment for us, Brock. We just come in here and like podcast whatever room now.
Do you want to, you and I could do
tenants.
One, maybe not in this room,
like,
but we'll do one next week.
I was going to say,
I can't do next week. I'm not here next week. I have to
in
say
2 weeks from now. But
yeah. November 14th next year. You have to help me make this happen. If this continues on. That's when we started. That's when I started YouTube and the podcast. If this continues and turns into something, I don't care who's living in that 212 room. I want to go back to that room for the 50-second episode.
Okay.
Listen, we can make that happen.
Yeah. You two
are
the people.
Are you bringing
the people?
Yeah.
Ooh.
Oh.
Well, shit, if it really works,
I think
I'll just
that
be
has
able
to
fly
happen.
Out.
All right.
That's fair.
Listen, I like the PMA.
G7?
Here
we
go.
We're talking Spirit Airlines.
We're doing PJs?
Frontier.
Not a private
no carry on.
Yeah, Economy Plus if he pitches in for it.
Yeah, of course.
Yeah.
He can upgrade himself.
Otherwise, you're pretty well fucked.
Coming up.
Really?
Yeah, I went and spent $95 to upgrade to, I think I spent about $130 in total upgrading my flights for the next week.
Is it worth it?
Where are you going?
Long flights is worth it.
Yeah. Italy next week. Oh, right. Saturday.
Anytime I would fly overseas, I would always get Economy Plus just because it's so much more.
Yeah.
I think just better.
The way
from
Minneapolis to Paris, I think it was like $30 just to go to an exit row. Dude. I'm like, yeah.
Absolutely. Yeah. No brainer. Absolutely. No brainer. Especially coming off a hitch off the ship and like a big chunk of change in the pocket. Yeah. And I was like, ooh, Economy Plus, let's go.
Yeah. I'll sit in the cabin. Hell yeah.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah.
Meanwhile, fucking Quentin's where all the luggage is. Fucking in the bag.
How much was that ticket?
I'm in steerage.
They actually paid me.
Oh, really?
Yeah, to work back there.
Ballast. Did they pay you for DM too?
Yeah, no.
Oh, no.
That's why I'm used to it.
We'll divert off that topic real fast. Yeah,
others in this building are going to hear it. They're going to come running down here.
They are.
What'd you say? You offered it up?
Snip it out.
Yeah.
I don't know much about what goes on, but I know that's a hot button.
Trust me, it's better if you don't.
I just,
for your sanity, at least, right?
I just know when people come back and they're all pouty.
Yeah. Me? I know I'm not talking about you.
Is it like a fat lip that the pigeons poop on?
Oh,
kind of thing?
Yeah. I don't know what that means either. Yeah,
pigeons aren't real anyway, but that's fine.
What?
Fat lip pigeons pooping on?
You don't know what that means either.
Pigeon pooping on the fat lip?
Dude, that's literally a literal thing. Yeah. That's not figurative at all.
What
if
you're talking
sticks
about?
Out so far because you're pouting so hard, the pigeon poops on it and you eat pigeon shit.
Well, let's back it up. That's a literal thing?
Yes.
Well, it's a
literal thing.
I don't know about literal.
I haven't heard that one.
It's a common colloquialism.
There you go. That's the right word.
You're coming out strong with those Scrabble words.
Of course.
I like it.
Scrabble.
Can you spell that? Let's bring Tristan back into this.
Scrabble.
You want me to spell Scrabble?
Yeah, Scrabble.
My answer is no to both, by the way.
Country of origin, please.
I misspell my own name 3 times a week, so this one's all you, Tristan.
Wait, what was the word?
I won the spelling bee.
Colloquialism. Colloquialism, like as in it's a colloquial term.
Listen, if you're going to be on this podcast, you can't make words up.
Now sponsored by Miriam Webster.
It's going to be a fucking channel.
Dictionary.com.
Might I interest you in a 3 free months of Babbel when you purchase 3 promo code hacks?
For English.
Yes, you
know,
learn English.
I've actually been using Duolingo.
You're going to drop a competitor after I throw back?
No, that isn't the competitor. That is the brand.
This is why we don't have any real ads, is because it always devolves into
contention.
Roles,
yeah.
You know?
If you were a walking brand deal, what would you choose? Like, any brand?
Any brand that I could advertise?
Yeah.
Ooh.
I want to ask everybody. Because it gives you like almost an insight to like your personal feed.
Yeah, absolutely.
As a person.
I'm trying to think if there's anything.
A walking brand.
I don't know. I just kind of spit that out.
Absolutely swear by and I'm married to. I have no idea.
No, come back to you, Paul. No.
Cat hat.
That's hard.
Of course.
Now, see, I feel like, like 5 years ago that fits. I feel like girls have taken it.
Absolutely. Along with LL Bean.
Yeah, and somehow the Stanley Cup thing, it's like that's been the thermos of the working man for 100 years, and now all of a sudden
it becomes like trendy.
It fits in a cup holder, so we're going to lose our
shit. For a second, I was thinking hockey, but I get what you're saying.
No, trust
me. I get what you're saying.
Growing up doing hockey and then seeing now when I Google Stanley Cup, I get a fucking insulated mug with a straw.
How the times have changed.
Lord Stanley's rolling over in his grave.
You know what you do, Shelby?
No, I feel like, you know how Hunter called me out at that one dinner for like not following anything? Do you remember? Were you there?
Yeah, that was a little rude.
It was very awkward.
He was aggressive about it.
It was a little rude. I feel like I brought it. I'm giving it too much power because I think it too often.
You do.
But, shout out to you, Hunter Wickman.
Yeah, Hunter. Ooh. A little awkward, buddy.
Ooh. No, you're good.
Yeah, we know you're watching.
Yeah, totally.
But yeah, no, like we're not like super big. Like we joke all the time that my dowry was my DeWalt tool collection. So like I feel like I could add to that. I'd be all right.
The fucking lottery.
Yeah, see.
Let's just say that.
Yeah. Now I wish we had a Milwaukee guy in here to stir some shit up.
Oh, that's fair.
Big Milwaukee guy. You gotta.
I'm a medium. I'm okay. I'm a medium. Milwaukee guy. Medium.
Mid.
He only goes to the M12.
Yeah. Mid. I don't even. You lost.
Yeah, he's a big Milwaukee guy. He's got the M12 heated jacket.
That's right. Along with everybody else in the shipyard.
Hey. Hey.
No, that's why I won't buy a heated jacket because Milwaukee's the only one I get, and I'm not going to buy a fucking Milwaukee. When DeWalt comes out with one, I'll get one.
There you go.
Yeah.
All right.
Is that like the brand?
DeWalt. Show some respect here.
I mean, it's either Big Red or Big Yellow.
DeWalt, friend of the pod.
Yeah. Do you need reliable tools?
Do you need to get that really tough nut off of there? Yeah. You have our DeWalt impact wrench. Yeah.
What about you, Justin?
You feel like snapping a 3/4-inch bolt? Boy, do we have a...
Break out the big bastard.
Yeah, flex volt. Up to 80 on that impact. 3/4-inch impact, 40 volts. Rip
done.
That bad boy right
done.
Off.
Done.
1,000 foot-pound of torque.
Dude, it's easy. Fucking wild. If that is the one ad deal we get out of this, I would be so fucking excited.
Man. Dude, I'm
gonna, a big bag for that one.
Oh my goodness.
A big bag?
I started emailing people.
Excuse me.
You know,
yeah. Here we go.
When did you, what did you start emailing?
I started emailing about brand deal.
Wait, who?
Did you?
So who'd you hit up?
Yeah,
hit
who was your first email?
My first email was Liquid Death.
Liquid Death.
That's a good one.
Man.
Interesting that you're trying to copy. This is, isn't that an energy drink?
No, it's just water.
It's water. Yeah.
So they branded water.
Yep. But they sell it in aluminum cans. It's responsible.
Quinn was the first person I ever saw drink it, but it showed up somewhere and
so
I was like,
here's the real question. How much do you pay for water in a can?
How
did
it's
you drink
like it?
$2.50.
It's
no more than
like a smart water.
I think that's fair. I think it's
that first game night we had.
It's a right. Sick fucking can, and I think
damn, I can. One comes in a black can.
You have.
So then you really feel like a badass when you drink your carbonated water.
Yeah, like
I hate carbonated water.
So here's my favorite thing.
Oh yeah, there it is.
They say the sign of a good podcast is just like hanging out with people and chilling, and we've devolved to that to the point where you guys are having one conversation and Paul and I are having another.
Yeah,
great for a hangout.
Perfect,
but not awesome.
Not awesome.
Like
podcast.
I said, we'll figure it out. All right.
But
Quinn's gonna cut it up later. It's okay.
I wanna
while I play Fortnite with Tristan. Oh yeah,
Tristan.
Oh,
there you go. What are you sponsored by?
Oh shit, dude, that's you good. Had so.
Hold on, time out. You just skirted that question, Chubb. You didn't.
You said skirted.
I meant to say skirted. I'm sorry.
I said DeWalt.
Yeah, she's the only.
Oh, you did say DeWalt. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. We have a very blue collar relationship.
You can't tell.
Yep. DeWalt, Carhartt.
We fitted just fine.
It is fine out here.
Dropping DeWalt and Carhartt, I feel like it's like, all right, have these people lived out of a vehicle? And
yes.
Have these guys been nomads at some point? Yes. Yes, they have.
Likely.
Because these are the things that hold them.
Yeah.
Do you need more time, Christian?
No, I can come up with something.
I got a question.
For me?
No, for them.
Oh, okay. I would say either like Muscle Farm creatine or Kessler's whiskey.
That makes sense. Both of them together.
This is a mixture of the both.
Is it like the modern white Russian?
Yeah.
Nobody said Kratom?
I thought that was just like an automatic for all of us.
Implied.
Is it a brand?
All of us in the podcast.
That's fair.
Is there big Kratom?
There is big Kratom.
But
Red
me and Quentin
Dawn,
buy.
Oh, dude.
Me and
are we going to get into something?
Buy that cheap Kratom.
Yeah. Might have opened the crate.
Well, Wild Bill's Tobacco.
So you say. So you say you're not going with the brand name. Like, you're shooting. You're not going to shoot for the brand name Kratom because it's too far out there, but you chose Kessler's whiskey. Which is also unknown.
Only because I think it's humorous.
Well known here, not well known in other states.
In a state that shows up as just a black dot on the alcoholism map, yes. Kessler's is no,
or any plastic bottle liquor.
Have you ever seen that map?
We even better.
It's a plastic wild.
Somebody sent us that video where it was like top 50 drunkest counties in the United States, and literally all but four of them were in this state. And I was like,
yeah.
I like Marinette County is like a dark, dark red.
Black.
Where are we moving to?
There's a guy who did a follow-up to it, and he's like, for those of you thinking that there's one dry county, and he zooms in on where Lake Winnebago is, he's like, that's a lake. Don't worry. That white spot, no people there. Yeah. That's water. Like, we know what you were thinking. Well, it's not all black. Look right there. It's like,
Oh, no, there's like one good community.
No.
Wisconsin's a very drunk community. I think a list of 20 cities. That were in like the top 10 list of most bars per like street corner.
I know what you're talking about. Bars and churches. I also want to say that
great combination
that comes out of your mouth, I love it. Don't stop talking ever.
What do you mean, dude? You make me feel like it's just talking.
You want to ruin the compliment? Make it weird?
Why would you think I would do that?
Thank you. That's what I thought.
How could I?
I don't know.
What were you thinking I was going to say?
Nothing.
Did you make it weird?
All right, that's enough.
All right.
No reverse psychiatry.
Once again, dictionary.com.
I will say that since becoming like a bartender up here, like I work just irregularly, like a one weekend a month, but an old fashioned is like not a thing that I feel like young people typically order. anywhere else in the world.
And if you make
world?
Them wrong really? Around here,
oh my God. Will get the old fashioned culture is deep. Like, really? It is. Oh my God.
At least you're not making them at a supper club, because then the fucking standard's higher.
They would tell me those blue
especially
hairs.
Especially if they don't have teeth.
Right. Yeah.
So what?
They just download things real fast, and they say, "Give me more."
Well, where I work, it's like the old fashioned mix, bitters, whiskey, and then sweet or sour, cherries or mushrooms. Like it's like everybody. Well, yeah, brandy.
You don't put an orange in there.
Not where I work. That sounds very weird. Fancy. I'm
See,
sorry.
That's so anywhere
I
outside
crack
of here.
Open equal amounts of Busch Light, and I make old fashioned. It's like about equivalent.
Really?
Yeah.
Like
yeah.
Busch Light goes in an old fashioned.
No. But the same people drink them.
Like, that's about
she's
the
equivalent of the two popular Busch Latte.
Yeah, Busch lattes.
I like that they finally gave in and just made Busch lattes.
Yeah, exactly.
Just the new can. Yeah.
Might as well.
So people always called them Busch latte. So they did a branding where it was just it said
Busch latte.
Yeah.
Gosh,
that's like
just gotta embrace the suck.
So you say you live under a rock. When people ask what there is to do here, I always give the answer: if you like to get drunk and look at trees, we've got a good spot for you. What I'm hearing in the fact that he hasn't heard the term Busch latte is he's done neither of those.
Neither.
Because it is the exclusive drink.
Big club
for those who look at trees.
Yeah. I feel like every region has their where I went to school was hams.
Yeah,
everything was hams.
I grew up in Pennsylvania on the good side, so it's Icy Light
or Icy Light. Yeah,
yeah. Icy Light. Yeah. If you're outside of Pittsburgh,
we get a couple.
Shout out to Rolling Rock, huh?
Ooh. Yeah. My dad grew up in that little town.
I had a friend who the liquor store was running a special on hams, so he bought
Christmas
like 40 cases, and they built a throne out of hams. Mm-hmm. He had, and they just. What the fuck was that?
I'm hungry.
He's
up
just
in
whispering
here.
Sweet nothing
so,
in your ear.
So cheap beer trivia. When did Pabst win its blue ribbon?
Ooh. I think.
We knew idea. This. This was great at like idea. A. This was at like a fair.
Yeah.
Like it literally was a.
Yeah, I think it was in the early days, but I couldn't tell you what the early days were for that beer. I know it's been a while, but. One of the older breweries, I think, right?
I want to say 1897.
Yeah, I was going to say, it's pretty back there.
We'll wait for oh, I thought you were going to fact check me there.
Do you Googleize
it? I wanted to do a beer trivia.
So the big one in Chicago was Old Style, which I'm sure is also sort of filtered up here a little
Never
bit,
heard
right?
Of her.
Yeah, so the Chicago stuff, get a little bit of here, and I went to school in Ann Arbor, so you got quite a few people from Chicago mm-hmm. bring the Old Style. Mm-hmm. And there's nothing like watching a guy sit at a picnic table and crack one of those at 5 a.m.
My grandpa all the time, Old Style.
Just going to watch the sunrise.
Gotta make you proud.
Yeah, just the kind of haphazardly keeping the brown bag on it, but like, he's giving up.
Yeah, that's fair.
I wish we would have like said something. We said this even as we were coming home from it, but we went to like a beer fest last weekend. Down in Green Bay. Like one of Paul's buddies runs a beer podcast.
Really?
Called Pour Another Round.
Pour Another Round.
Yeah.
Ooh. That's awesome.
Shout out in Green Bay.
Maybe that's a contact you get in touch with when we finally start Tristan's alcoholism podcast.
Is he like a
intriguing
followers of the podcast will know that.
I didn't listen to the recent episodes.
I went to high school with both him and his brother. And they both live in Green Bay now.
That's very cool.
And now we live in Marinette. So here we go.
The plan was to basically get Tristan to a point where we could then document his road to recovery.
I'm going to play it back so well that I'm going to become an alcoholic.
Because if he just had a beer podcast, it'd be like, cool, we get a following. But if he actually became an alcoholic, then people would be invested in him getting fixed. It would bring out emotion.
Tristan, look me in the eye. You need better friends.
Yeah, you're probably right.
You can tell she only knows a lot about this relationship through the podcast, because if she thinks we're friends with Tristan, that's weird.
I know.
Got him.
I say that.
Needed to watch this earlier episode or recent episode.
Yeah.
Just the kidding. No.
Okay, what do we got here?
I told her not to show me the answers yet.
Oh.
So it will after I ask for them.
Interesting. Dates back to 1516. Is that right around the siege of Munster, or was that 1415?
Half the words that come out of your mouth, I don't know what the fuck they mean.
Siege? Did that one get you?
Yeah, it actually did. I actually don't know what that means. I could spell it though. S-E-I-G-E.
Just because you keep seeing ads for Rainbow Six Siege pop up when you're buying video games, or what?
No.
Okay, just checking.
I'm having a really good time right now.
You're Kate out, aren't you, Q?
I'm fucking Kate out, baby.
Oh, bro. Hey, I'm being a dick. I don't know why.
I'll
tone it down.
It happens.
You're in a salty mood, aren't you, Brock?
What's that?
You're in a salty mood tonight, aren't you?
I always am.
I feel like it's more than normal, though, tonight.
It's been a week.
Did something happen earlier?
He's got to get it out. He's not going to be on the podcast next week.
I was going to say, he's going to be in Italy, and he's going to have to, you know, put on his Italian accent.
It's going to be an interesting adventure. Yeah. No, I had a great day today. I left work way earlier than I normally do.
So it was a good thing.
Went dog for a walk. Spent a couple minutes.
You went dog for a walk.
I've never seen the dog.
How's that dog?
Went and took a dog for a walk. You know,
you mean your
did
cat?
Its thing.
Your cats?
No, it's not my
your
dog
six
either.
Six cats?
I don't have cats.
That's right. Okay.
Segue. Enough of your conversation.
Well, that was a forcible segue.
I didn't mean that. Didn't
talk about fine. Bullying from the podcast about, director.
I'm mad enough to say that was a little harsh.
Well, if it's about me, I'll stand.
But if I say you look like a cat person, is that an insult? Do you take that as an insult?
Depends on how they feel about cats.
So that's the logical answer.
If I call a cat person, like he has cats hidden in his house somewhere that we haven't
hidden?
Seen yet.
So they've been to my home.
Oh, good.
No evidence of cats. They still are convinced I have
there
cats.
There was plenty of everywhere. Tiny balls on the floor. You may say they're Nerf bullets.
Nerf guns.
You may say they're
Nerf guns.
What else? Cricket balls.
Tiny
but
well,
you're
balls
not
me. On the floor.
Yes.
I'm convinced
of
that we have
some.
That we have the best setup possible because our neighbor has outdoor cats, so we don't have mice. So
yeah.
Like this is
that's
the fact.
This is the premium setup. So I appreciate cats.
We never have to deal with the cat, but we do have to listen to when his cat dies.
When it dies, how many times does it die?
Well,
only one has
died.
Nine. He gets. He just gets
he gets really emotional.
He just gets very emotional when his cat dies.
Yes.
We've only witnessed one so far.
It was pretty rough. It was memorable for both of us.
One of nine.
I like that you're still using present tense for it. It's throwing everybody off.
He's still pretty fucked up.
Why not?
That's why that damn cat time to go through.
I actually really love you guys' house.
So,
yeah, we've been
like, I don't mean that as like, oh, I'm just like saying a compliment. Like, I actually really like you guys' house. Like, I want it given to me.
You should ask Shelby about how she feels about it right now.
You don't like it? Or is it because it's all the construction stuff?
Yeah.
Wait, let me describe to you what cooking dinner looks like in our house currently.
Yeah. It's comical.
We don't have lights, so I have to wear my hiking headlamp.
I love it already.
And we have like an LED
hear,
shop
like,
light that will
down.
Turn on.
Yep.
And then I like cook my little whatever I'm cooking, and then we got dinner. And
nice.
It is. I thought I was done living in a camper, but now I'm just living in a big camper.
Big with
camper. A little running
with
water,
a
which is nice.
Right. With a pointy roof.
Yeah, we got a little A-frame.
Wait, have
so.
You gotten a chance to go to their house? Have you been there?
No, I haven't been there.
He's dipped on us both
that's
times.
That's right.
Yeah, motherfucker.
One time, I
dude,
think.
Their house is so awesome. I'm not gonna lie.
No, next time we have a bonfire, you guys gotta come out.
Damn, that's sad because I won't be there.
How much longer are you guys gonna be here for?
The foreseeable future.
Okay. Hey, you know okay. They live here, right?
Yes. I know they have a house here.
Yeah.
Oh, so damn it. Now
so
I
he's
look
just
like
asking questions that are obvious.
That's it. But you guys, again, we'll have to do something. Just because Quentin goes away doesn't mean we have to stop being friends. So.
Oh, that's true. That's so true.
Yeah. This is good because I've gotten in the habit of anytime I hear murmurings of a little project going on at work, I get to go, oh, this is a goddamn Paul project, isn't it? and then sure enough, it is.
Damn TMMG guys.
Sorry.
Every time we got TMMG working on something, I was like, gosh, I like Paul, but he gets roped into some bullshit.
Yeah, I do.
Like,
absolutely get roped into bullshit.
Always the worst
like,
project.
I do. I do 100%.
The worst project.
I do feel very bad for
dude,
you.
Listen,
do you do it to yourself? Yeah. This is what I want to know.
Probably to an extent. I can admit that.
Gotta put the hammer down.
Yeah, maybe.
Put it down, Paul.
Part of my job is to be the person
the
that
yes
says
guy.
Yes, though. Not the yes man is in they tell me what to do and I say yes, but the yes man is in.
Can you do
are
that?
Are you able
sure,
to support
we'll make
this?
More
and I
money.
Say, yeah, sure.
Yeah.
Well, the nice thing is because everybody just broadly categorizes it as TMMG, no one's ever going to throw your name at it. No one ever goes, oh, it's a Paul. I go, oh, it's a Paul project because I.
Yeah, you keep that TM
you know.
To a minimum.
I see
you know.
Yeah. Well, I see all the facets of it. And then when someone goes, because I love it when someone will walk into our office, oh,
TMMG, and then the Quint will be like, what did I do? It's like,
yeah. No, something I did, I'm sure, yeah. Every time.
I'm like, I know who's behind this one.
The big tall guy.
Paying attention to the man, yeah, behind the curtain.
Yeah. Whenever I hear that word out, it's usually not good, and I'm always like, yeah, fuck those guys. Those guys suck.
Oh, geez, yeah. Word, meanwhile, yeah, it's TMMG? A sticker on your
hat. I was just going to say, yeah, and then I walk out with a TMMG sticker on my
helmet. You've reached the point that I do just with engineering in general. Engineering, fuck this. I'm like, those guys.
Yeah, fuck those guys.
Yeah, they're not us.
Are you in the engineering department?
I feel like we have our own boat.
Okay.
Yeah. So Brock and Tristan are both in waterfront engineering, I guess. Yeah. I don't know actually what your official title is, so I'm not going to impose.
The doll.
That's perfect.
Brock's the doll of Jersey.
Is waterfront engineering about twice a week, somebody slaps on there that I'm the subject matter expert in something that I'm about
days
into?
I feel like you get roped into things as well with your own flavor.
Yeah, that's why I'm catching a lot of flights in the next couple months is a bunch of stuff that's way outside of my scope. But
oh, boy.
Oh, well.
But hey, here we are.
Yeah.
There's worse things. Are.
What else you got on?
Yeah, what you got on that list?
It's on your crib notes there,
Chief. Are we going to go through this list?
I may or may not
beer
be
trivia.
Out.
Well, you brought something up on the screen.
Half of them Shelby fucking asked me. She literally studied so hard that she beat me to my own questions.
Well, you didn't answer.
You got to step yourself up.
So what else was on? What else was on your list?
Okay, how about this one? No.
No.
We'll drill you for a little bit longer.
I was going to say, you sounded really upset about that.
Yeah, you did.
No, I'm just scared.
I'm not sure. No, this one's easy. This one's a good one. Yeah. What is like the either like the weirdest or like the most random or just like the wildest job that you've worked in your life? Because I love these stories. So people have done some like weird shit for either money or for to help somebody
weirdly
out.
Enough, a couple months ago, I actually had this company called TMMG.
Yeah, I knew it was coming.
You sold yourself a money on the corner? Yeah. Weirdly enough.
6 months actually, of his life down the drain.
I really haven't done anything.
What?
That weird.
I think the like weirdest weird thing job? You've done was actually, the photo shoot you did not too long
say,
ago for Valentine's
thing.
Day.
So I take photos for companies.
Okay.
Like they'll send me their products and I'll take photos of them.
Well,
and
that's cool.
I get paid for it.
Yeah.
And most of the time I get to keep the product and there's some fucking weird things that I get from people.
What is the weirdest product you've received?
Yeah. All
right. I can tell what you're segueing into.
I want to see where this goes.
Should we break it out?
It's actually Tristan's now.
Let's do a demonstration.
No more demonstrations.
Here we go.
Yeah. So, can we not again?
All right.
We'll do it on Paul this time. It's fine.
Here. Yeah.
How?
I don't know if I want to be the willing subject here.
It's like so the one I recently did was like a whip.
It's a crop. And a blindfold.
Yeah. That's why I have the flowers in there.
Yeah. For exactly what.
Okay.
Tasteful.
Crop, I was like okay, plus blindfold. You can draw the right conclusions.
Some lovely leather filigree on it. It's nice.
Filigree.
I'm trying for them now. We're searching for them. It technically wasn't even filigree, but I had to work it in.
Yeah,
dude, that's all right. Those words, that's a good vocab word. The thesaurus.
Yeah, it was embossed.
Wait, I want to look. They're not weird.
So one of the weirdest ones I've done, also photography based, I took some lovely aerial and ground level photos of the Burger King and Taco Bell locally.
That sounds amazing.
I'm sure you got paid a pretty penny for it. So yeah, cool.
He actually does get a lot of money for that.
I was supposed to. I don't know if the check ever came for that one, but that's a different story.
No,
well, the other stuff I've done, like industrial aerial stuff, that pays pretty well.
Yeah, I was going to say, I feel like companies like that would pay well for that because it's like their mainline marketing stuff.
Yeah, and they do them every so many years, and they used to pay someone to do it with a helicopter.
Oh,
so
yeah.
When I'm up against...
So, like, the budget is there.
Yeah, you know? So
like, how much for the helicopter? Yeah, you pay 20K? Okay, I'll do it for 19.
Yeah, I'll take 10.
Well, they used to be running, like, $850 an hour for a helicopter. It's like,
Well, give me 75%, we'll call it.
I can charge twice as much as I would feel reasonable, and you're still coming out ahead. So no, that's worked out well.
That's called a win-win-win.
Yeah, right? It's a good time.
Win-win-win.
I cleaned boats for a summer, which oddly enough had me pretty close to a nice little crew job on a yacht once upon a time. Yeah. And then the sale of said yacht fell through and I didn't end up moving to Florida to do that.
So my sister used to work on the fuel dock in the summertime and I would go clean boats with her in the summer.
That. Yeah, I worked at the marina in Menominee for about 10 years. I did that. So
okay,
lots of interesting stuff out of that.
So my most interesting was high school.
Yeah, you kept talking about being a...
Yeah, so I hawked popcorn at my own baseball stadium.
Popcorn hawker.
Wait. You hucked popcorn at poor people?
Hawk.
Hawks popcorn. Like,
excuse me, Mr. Baseball player. That's what that's called.
I would walk around. I would walk around the stadium and sell popcorn to people. But the problem was, it was a rip. It was a ripoff.
He was too tall.
I don't believe it.
Like, who the fuck is talking?
I'll buy some popcorn and get your fucking head out of my way.
No, it sucked because, like,
that's funny.
Obviously, they paid minimum wage. It was a stupid high school job,
right?
But I had to drive 30 minutes to get there and 30 minutes back. So, like, the gas I paid
was
probably wasn't even worth it because you only actually worked probably 3 hours for a game, and then they cut you off at like the seventh inning stretch.
Oh, I hate.
But even worse, even worse, it was a shitty minor league stadium, so the popcorn was $1 a bag.
Yeah,
they couldn't have even made like $1.25. So you got like
a chance, change
for the tip. Like no opportunity for that at all. Because nobody's gonna buy $1 bag of popcorn and give you $1 as a tip.
Right.
Because that's the smallest denomination they have at that point is a single dollar bill.
Yeah.
They're not gonna do it.
Yeah. No. We went from $1.50 to $2 a bag for ice.
Yep.
And just fucked you, man.
But you did.
What?
Where?
Here? No.
Oh.
Are you concerned?
Not here.
I take ice baths in there.
Do you?
Yeah. Fucking sucks.
So again.
Well, things happen in this apartment.
You might get some weird complaints from the people on that side because I fucking scream my brains off and they're probably like, what the fuck's going on?
I've never seen a girl come out of there. I don't know who's screaming.
Yeah,
that's fair.
Yeah.
So again, this is on his quest to make this a professional gig instead of DMT and sensory deprivation. You're doing Kratom and ice baths.
Yeah. Ice baths are really fucking good for you.
Everyone's got to have a stick, right?
Yeah. I don't think ice baths like a weird thing. That's like really, really good for you.
No, I'm sure it is.
Yeah. Oh, you're off.
Your mic is definitely off, pal.
Yeah, you're right.
Oh, there you go. That's why.
Okay. I got off. Yeah, right. My bad.
See, I enjoy just a nice bubble bath, but I don't know that I could do the ice bath thing.
Are you like Patrick Mahomes on the commercial with all the bath bombs?
I don't do a lot of bath bombs. I am pretty picky about my bubbles. And if there's a candle, that's got to coordinate.
You actually?
Preferred scent.
With the rose petals too?
Really? Before I came here.
While we play Fortnite.
All right.
I can't do it. That'd be tough.
That's electricity, water, don't mix, right? I mean,
yeah.
Depends on what you're looking for.
Favorite bath bomb is a toaster.
Hey, I like that. That was good. That was a good one.
You said, yeah, I like that.
That was a good one. I like that.
A little crazy. Okay.
Shelby.
You're up. You're going round robin.
Wait, do you know the question?
No.
What's your weirdest job you've ever done? Weirdest, funniest, I don't know. Think of something to say.
But I would say mine's probably like a toss up.
Yeah.
No, I'd say so my college job, I in the summers would be like the flagger, like the stop and slow person that you always feel really bad for in like the crazy heat, and it's just like I worked that job in a remote part of Pennsylvania. So like my second summer was like particularly terrible because we were on like the pipe crew, insert jokes here, and so we would be like in like the remote area, so like I would stop maybe like more Amish buggies in a day than I would actually stop
literal
cars.
I was gonna ask the Amish buggy question.
Absolutely.
But I'm like, I don't know if that's a Pennsylvania stereotype.
About the Amish after this for sure.
No.
They have cheese.
Well, yes.
I remember this one day though. Oh my gosh. Literally, my mom came home from work and she was like, how was your day? And I was like, literally, I squished a blueberry at 6:30 this morning and I counted how many ants came up to it. And that I saw zero cars. So that was like probably the worst job I've ever had.
Did you start messing with the ants at all? Like, ooh, what if we got a second blueberry? Where did they go?
What are they gonna do?
This is where Brock likes to introduce a little chaos.
Yeah, I see this.
Yeah.
No, it's like that, and then like how many like lyrics do you actually think you know? Like, because you're not allowed to put anything in your ears. So you're just like, can I sing this entire
the ultimate test.
Yeah. Queen song without actually looking up the lyrics.
You know what I used to do? I used to try to whistle entire songs. Instead of singing, I would just try that.
If you can't tell, we're the coolest people you've ever met. We just
play
in that apartment.
We talked about this before. You want to know what he was best at whistling? Dial-up tones. Nailed them every time.
What's that, man?
Never heard that. And we've come full circle.
Yeah, I like to throw a callback in every now and then.
See if people pay attention.
Weird, people will do out of boredom.
Yes.
Really though? For sure. Yeah. So I had a buddy who used to get bored in class and he would do this thing with his fingers where he would go all the way through and then opposite and then work all the way back and opposite and all the way through.
You're talking about me?
No.
I do that. I go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
No, it'd be 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. 4, 3, 2, 1. Four. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1.
Oh, I don't
4, 3, 2, 1, 4.
See, I go this way like and then back, but then I have to make sure it's equal, so I go this way.
It's
and
like it's like a very evil maniacal type of move, right?
Either that, or he's just got to hold the other hand right, so it looks like he's remembering something on guitar. Like he's just going over his tabs in his head, like. It's like, man, is he
gotta like stick your tongue out a little bit.
It's like, is that a tick or is he really trying to learn Freebird? Like,
he had a stroke. I want to get him.
Two different options there.
I like the idea that as you're trying to remember lyrics, you're doing it in real time, and you get to one like Freebird, and it's like, oh, I just gotta sit here for 3 minutes and tap it out before I can sing again.
Meanwhile, there's like no lyrics.
I can't remember the lyrics. Like you're just sitting there, it's like. Oh, too early. Damn it, every time.
Right, okay. Tristan.
Oh, the weirdest job I've ever done?
Mm.
I did the whole being a
Oh, yeah, you were a flipper too?
Yeah, I did. I did that for like a whole year.
Yeah.
It was not a good time.
Like, I know, it was so good.
I became the supervisor of summer help for that gig, supervisor, so I just drove in a truck the whole time.
All right.
But the weirdest job I ever did was shoveling snow off rooftops up when I went to school in Michigan Tech. Mm.
That makes sense.
It was not a fun... Yeah, it is. Is it that far away?
Oh, there you go.
But that was a scary-ass job, being up on rooftops.
I believe that.
And shoveling off the snow. That's no fun.
Yeah, I kind of got to do that on mine right now.
Snow is scary.
I only did three
That's
of them.
That's part of an A-frame.
I was gonna say the snow doesn't stay, so
flooding down.
Yeah, no, that's wild.
You were so high up sometimes,
really,
and like some of the slopes of some of the
houses.
Yeah, it was like
pitch,
almost like 75 degrees. I feel like.
Whoa.
Yeah, not a
fun. You should come shovel our house. You're probably pretty close to that number.
No, I'm retired from that.
Retired.
Oh, retired.
Hung up boots. No more.
Wait, Quinton. What? Did you give something for that already?
I did. I gave the photography thing.
Yeah, that is
wild. I've also shot this thing where apparently this is a normal thing where you like, I don't know what it's for, but you put your dog in it and then you hang your dog up. It's like
what
a hanger.
In the hell? Is that like a
hanging
pot?
Like a doggy bouncer?
Yeah, but the no, it's
no. I feel like this is a potted plant. You like hang in the
is
corner.
This like,
yeah.
Is this
yeah.
like all the videos that you see of people where it's like when the New York subway passed the law that you had to have a dog that fit in a bag?
I did see that.
So you got
yeah.
someone with like a
IKEA
yeah,
bag.
Yeah,
quick, you gotta look for something
hanging out the bottom.
Yeah. You gotta look this up.
Yeah,
let me see if I can find.
Do you know
it.
What we're
I
talking
see
about?
The largest,
Mom?
No, I don't. I want to see the largest dog possible in the smallest bag possible.
Like some. Yeah.
Oh, that's so they can like trim their nails.
What?
That might be what it's for.
Yeah.
Well, what? I mean, they're selling it with the nail clippers,
yeah,
so that tracks.
Like, no. They're having people hang their dogs on the subway. Is what they're doing.
I'm sorry, Quinton. Did you have to like
a dog, not a
rent? Did you have to like rent a dog to accurate pictures?
No,
that's a good question.
Like a perfect dog.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Like a perfect dog.
Ooh. It's not like it's not like a perfect dog. Like a pit bull. It's like
so let's discuss. What is the perfect dog?
You're gonna get canceled.
You're gonna
pit bull people.
You're gonna step on the third rail of the internet.
Well, no.
Pit bulls. What you got against Mr. Worldwide?
I don't even know. All right. I don't even know.
I did see this pretty epic bachelorette party where all the girls dressed up as pit bull. You know how people
as a pit bull or pit bull?
No, pit bull. Okay. Like people,
pit bull.
The one that shows up. It's like the guy who shows up in the pantaloons. Ah, 1880 or 1980. Son of a bitch.
Knickerbockers.
Yeah. Just got the powdered wig on. I thought you said 1790s.
Oh, missed it again.
Look at my leg warmers.
It's like some girl with a dog collar and like whiskers.
Just a little bit too jacked. Like I swear, with kids. Just.
Oh my god.
It's the friend of the group that's like a little too protective always.
Yes,
it's like,
absolutely.
She's really mean. No, she's just protective. She just doesn't know
so
you.
So it's like way too fitting.
Yeah, just strange men. She just goes after him. It's a whole thing.
She's only a little bit of an ankle biter.
Yeah. Gotta have an extra insurance policy.
Yeah. What is
just bad
sip.
Owners.
I was gonna say, I also took pictures for these people too. Those are probably my weirdest
problems. Is that picture of the two small children in your picture?
Did you
rent those shows?
Rent the kids.
Best friend.
Is it?
Yo, yeah, click on that picture. Let me see that Marco. Shit.
He's been on the podcast, actually, in Charleston.
Oh, that was that one guy.
Yeah. These are what we told...
Yeah, except it's not the koozie that sits around your neck. Yeah, this is actual pouch with a straw.
This is actually the first thing I ever took photos of. And I remember being like, there's no way they're making money. Dude, they are killing it.
Yeah. Dude, the weirdest shit makes money.
I think it's because it's like a gag gift, but then it works.
The weirdest shit makes money, dude.
Yeah.
The
weirdest shit. Small unit prices, creative alcohol delivery systems.
Easy packaging. Yeah. You know, they can just ship it anywhere they want to without a problem. They can put it in a flat rate box for all they care.
Yeah, and you're never gonna buy just one. It's always gonna be my buddy's in a lake.
We're going to the beach. Let's get a pack of 30.
Yeah, we're gonna go to the lake house. Can we get custom ones?
Yeah, like, for the weekend.
Put on my bachelor party and print
it. Yeah.
All of them are gonna have one with a clock when you know they show up and do the flame of flame.
Go back up top right corner. Yeah, Bride Tribe.
Oh yeah. Oh, Bride Tribe.
Yeah, that's exactly what they're going for.
Huge Nashville bachelorette
sit back
party.
And relax.
That's screaming at me.
Come on. Beach, please. Yeah, for sure. There's so much scalability.
I can just see like 10 drunk white girls with like Nashville wasn't ready for us in the Instagram caption.
Oh, that's right.
I'm sorry, did you know me circa?
Circa last week.
yeah, right.
That's your boy?
Yeah, it's kind of weird, actually. It's kind of freaking me out. I'm not going to lie.
I notice he's not wearing the rainbow one, Quentin. What's wrong with him?
What the hell?
He got a problem?
Be canceled.
Wait, the rainbow one.
Oh, yeah, I see that.
Rainbow beads, bruh.
I see what you're saying.
Oh, perfect for Mardi Gras. I bet those are on sale right now.
Dude, man, for real. Yeah. Also something someone could easily sell on the street at Mardi Gras.
Yeah.
Well, I got business on top of business, bro. I don't know if sell beads at Mardi Gras.
No, I'm talking about these things on the screen.
It's a different currency
those
exchange.
Those would be like, epic ones to get, though.
It's a transaction system.
I don't know what you'd have to do to get one with like full alcohol at Mardi Gras. Like if you're getting those beads, like the
new business model. I'm going to sell those at Mardi Gras full of shitty liquor.
Yeah.
That's what I'm saying, though. But, like, what
and
are
color
you...
color it with something fun.
Yeah. That's genius.
A Zima and the adult Capri Sun there.
That's genius.
Listen, I've got background in popcorn hawking. I'm perfect for this.
I love it.
And he's going to be throwing... he's going to have to make all kinds of change for these.
Yeah, that's right.
Well, see, the best part is like I can reach far enough that I can just like make transactions from afar.
No, he's going cashless. Right? He's going to hold out the little square reader, 15%, 20%, or 30%. Can I have you sign with your finger? Awesome. Thank you.
I hate those things.
Yeah, custom tip.
Don't bring those things up. I hate those things.
Why do you hate them? Dude, it's the backbone of small business commerce.
He doesn't like to tip.
Freaks me out.
The square?
I'm a huge tipper.
I said Squarespace.
Huge.
Obviously, Square Portal is great for transactions. Squarespace.
But hey,
No.
Oh, no.
Come on, we need some money.
Do you need to build your website?
Hurry, calm down.
Use a promo code for Wix. Build your own website.
I was going to say, Quinn's a big Wix guy.
Did I talk about how long have we been doing this podcast?
Talked about Wix? I don't know. I sit in the back of the office. He sits in the front of the office. That's, you know.
Shut the fuck up.
You're on Wix all day, Q? Is that what I'm getting at?
I see Fiverr and Wix.
Well, because it's like, all right.
Shame.
I could double dip and get paid.
Absolutely.
Come on now.
Dude, I don't care. Hustle all day long, bro.
Dude, you're a contractor. You're there to rob us blind and do no work. Yeah. We know how it works.
We're just living up to our reputation, all right?
Come on.
Yeah,
they're almost people, so like you can almost get mad at them.
Right.
It's like half a person.
Yeah. Contractors are people too, bro.
I don't think the hashtag's going to catch on.
I'm not buying that.
What do you do to make a double contractor?
I don't know. Work on Wix all day, I guess. I'm contracted by the contract, I guess.
Yeah. That's contractception. Not to be confused with contraception.
Contraception.
So, it would have been funny if he just would have went with it.
You touched on a pet peeve of mine here.
What?
Oh, no.
And that is the...
You don't like that?
You hate abortion that much, bro. Yeah.
Come on, man. A little pet peeve of mine. Okay, yeah, sorry.
He's goddamn... Between the rainbow bag and... it's the fact that we allow movies to change the meaning of words, and that now when we say inception, we think of within something.
Correct.
And it's just not what it was.
You're absolutely right.
It's just not what it is.
It's true.
Is it?
It's true.
It's the planting
it's the
of something.
Of,
yeah. Yeah, it's the beginning of it's the
correct.
Yeah.
So the inception of this podcast.
Yeah, beginning of
happened a while ago, November whatever 17th or whatever you said.
14th. Yeah, yeah. And 14th. The inception 13th. Of other things, somewhat something contradictory like to contraception. It's a whole thing.
Yeah.
That brings up another one. If I say the word ultimate,
you think frisbee? I don't know where you're going with on here.
How would you define ultimate?
The ultimate is like the top or the best of the best.
Yeah. It's actually
because the penultimate is the one before the best.
Yeah, but ultimate is actually it's last. It's the last one said. It's the top.
The end
is the ultimate.
Mm. Oh,
but because you know we look at it the other way. You know, if you rank something from 10 to 1, the ultimate one is number one, and the last penultimate frisbee. Is previous.
Correct. Yeah.
Yeah. Hmm. I won't even bring up the fact that bi-weekly can mean every other week or twice a week.
Correct.
I knew that one.
Biennial is twice a year versus biannual, which is every 2 years.
Well, if you ask me to do something bi-weekly, you know which one I'm picking. Every 2 weeks.
Okay.
I don't have one of those.
Quinn's like, I very clearly flex. Have a preference in my bi-weeklies.
Yeah.
So you wouldn't want a podcast twice a week?
Ooh. What was the...
Let's do that.
Way to put them up to it.
We were talking about, literally, because we're old.
We're not fucking old. Yeah.
We buy shelled pistachios, but they're actually unshelled. Like,
is this like the sweet, unsweetened tea?
What?
I don't know what that one is.
A lot going on.
When you go somewhere, they give you unsweetened tea. It's like, it's not unsweetened.
It's just
had sugar to remove the sugar. Yeah. Just fucking tea.
No, like on the bag at Costco, it literally says shelled pistachios, and then they're all without the shell inside. And I find that like...
Very contradictory.
Yeah, I just don't understand that. Because if they were...
I'm fucking with you.
They're not deshelled. Well, they're just... I don't know.
Do it as a past tense verb. They have been shelled. Previously shelled.
I need more of that sentence on the bag.
Yeah, we need that's a marketing faux pas at that point.
The shells in the bag with those.
No.
In the bag?
No, not in the bag.
Well, the shells aren't in the bag. You can buy the shells separate if you really like it. Personally, I like to I like the act of opening them up. I like to open a bag and pick apart some shells on the pistachios.
Like throw them
on
the floor.
Those are weirdos.
What's that?
Okay. Those are weirdos. Everyone likes to convenience aspect to them.
Here's the real problem is the price of things. Thanks, Biden. The fucking pistachios are too goddamn expensive for me to just be rattling through them. Having the shells on there helps me pace myself a little bit, and it doesn't go straight to my hips, you know?
You got a rash. What if I told you the bags are the same amount of weight for the same price?
Ooh.
So you're paying for shells?
Exactly.
But it's part of just not consuming them quite as fast.
Hey, Mr. Smart Guy. You actually burn more calories eating pistachio than...
That's celery.
Listen, dude, how tough are those shells?
Yeah, because you have to open.
Are you going through the shell too?
Dude, you don't need to swing a 10-pound hammer to get a pistachio shell. Those are just the ads. You don't need to drop an elephant on it.
I don't remember who told me this, but somebody told me that now you actually lose calories eating pistachios.
Yeah, if you set them across the room and you throw away the shell and then come back and shell want to go throw it away and come back.
So then I'm assuming it is a myth.
It's a simple way.
Do you prefer shelled or unshelled? Because you could be sponsored by wonderful pistachios.
Right.
Like
shell would be... That's the same thing.
Well, shelled comes without a shell. Unshelled, well,
it would be regular.
Unshelled,
I just say pistachios.
Damn, yeah. Lost. See, it's contradictory. It's contradictory.
It just the problem my
is,
mind.
But I believe the thing you're looking for is celery.
Yeah,
not is pistachios.
It? I thought it was cucumbers.
No, it's celery.
Okay,
so look it up.
Burn more
look
calories
it up in a book,
eating
right?
celery.
Yeah.
Yes.
That must be right.
We don't know what dial-up is. You think this kid's heard of books?
Which is why I said it.
So there's actually buildings. There's actually buildings. If you could probably see it out your window where they keep a lot of books.
Mm-hmm.
And that predates dial-up even. It's called a library.
I love libraries.
Yeah, cards, whole thing.
Scrolls. Cards.
Yeah, like library cards?
Manuscripts.
I have a library card.
How about the microfiche?
Decimal system?
Index cards?
Ooh, even better.
I'm going to name this podcast Let's Fuck with Quinn.
You remember you, have you ever had to physically scroll through a card catalog?
Ooh.
A card
catalog?
How about
a Rolodex?
Yeah.
Ooh.
A Rolex?
What?
Yes,
I like
a Rolex.
A knockoff Rolodex and it's just a square so it doesn't spin.
Oh my gosh.
What the fuck is a... Wait, I really don't know these
predates the wheel.
I was pretty sheltered as a kid.
Clearly.
Ohio, man, that landlocked state. You just can't.
Yeah.
Fucking Ohio.
Oh, fuck Ohio.
I just went outside.
I hate Ohio so much.
Look at you.
Like, who wants to go to Cleveland?
No one.
No one. No one. Ever in any world wants to go to Cleveland. Nobody says, I'm going to vacation to Cleveland.
Listen, unless they're going to start the river on fire again, they have nothing for me. That happened. The Cuyahoga River was so polluted, it started on fire.
Oh, dang.
Even better.
Cuyahoga one?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Wait, what part of the state are you from?
Like, right.
It doesn't matter. It's Ohio. Yeah. Unpopulated part of
Ohio state.
So is that like Columbus-ish?
Yeah, we're like 2 hours north of I'm like 2 hours north of Columbus.
Okay.
But you live in far Charleston away.
Because you decided.
I know this Ohio is my favorite thing that you're like, people are moving to Ohio. It's like in the top five. I definitely moved to Charleston because it must have been in the top four.
So,
like,
so I worked with a guy on the ship that was from outside of Columbus, actually not quite as far as you were, but was moving to, I want to say, near Cincinnati.
Hilton. Oh.
But anyways, he was super.
Were you going to say Hilton Head?
Yeah. Everybody in Ohio goes to Charleston, Hilton Head, fucking Myrtle Beach. They all go there.
He was just super all about Ohio, and none of us could understand why.
Yeah.
It's like, dude, like, Ohio's like the most growing state ever. Like, that's got like the highest population. So, it's great. Like, and we just like looked up all these statistics. Yeah. Like, dude, you're wrong. Like, on all levels, you're wrong. What is so great about Ohio? So, Ohio.
You gotta live there. You gotta be there tonight.
One thing that I said that he didn't get, and I think you, based on that statement you make, there's this weird crossover and attitude and sort of even cadence of speech between what we would think of as like a Cali bro and a guy from Ohio. Like, if some guy comes up, he's like, yo, dude, it's like, think he's going to have a surfboard. Nope.
Just a
whole bunch of Buckeyes on his fucking tailgate.
I was going to say,
I will say
that. He just has a Buckeye in his cheek, and that'd be it.
That's a big thing in Ohio. It's like
the Ohio State. You can't spell any of those words. So calm down, bud.
All right. Ohio State's pretty good. Ohio. Yeah.
Do you know how many times I've seen signs where they fucked that up, though?
Oh, man.
Like, there was one when Urban Meyer had his whole thing going, and they're like, we stand with Urban Meyer, and they had Ohio spelt wrong on it.
Oh. It's
like, that's who you want in your corner. Go nuts.
Go nuts.
I feel like you get that with anything, though. The bad comes with the good.
It's like a big thing in Ohio where, like, everyone yearns to be a Cali boy, including myself.
That's because nothing good exists in the state, and we're yearn for something better.
I don't know about that. You have the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame and the Football Hall of Fame. Those are pretty
good. Have you ever been to either one of those?
Yeah, a couple times.
Oh, okay. Is that because there's nothing else to do there?
No. Maybe.
We went to that wedding. Do you remember that the same weekend that they were inducting people into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame?
Yeah. We went to a wedding in Cleveland. It sucked.
Really?
We had a great time
Scott
at the wedding.
Scott and Sarah, it was great.
We had a great time at the wedding.
Scott and Angie, geez.
Yeah, wedding was great.
All over the place.
Those Scott's other wedding.
Yeah. It's his sister, Scott. They're my cousins.
Ohio.
Okay.
Yeah.
But still, if you
go to Ohio. That's West Virginia. West Virginia.
Well, you have the Hall of Fame, Camp Football Hall of Fame, Rock and Roll Hall of Fame.
You've already listed those two.
Right? You have the best football in the country.
Hang on.
Where?
Texas.
Who's best football?
Where?
It's the best football in the country.
Okay. Best football of what?
High school.
High school?
Hey, college too, actually.
You're going to go high school now. Ohio State win?
You lost all
BCS
your viewers. You lost
recently?
All your viewers in Texas.
So, yeah.
All
so
of let's, them.
You just equated them to Ohio, and they're just all going to boycott you forever.
Name a high school that's known for football.
Madison.
Outside
never
of Ohio.
Heard of her.
Where?
Zanesville.
IMG? Did you throw IMG in there? Yeah. Where's IMG?
Yeah, it's Florida, but it's just a nationally known
school. Allen, Katy, you know, these
Trinity.
$60 million high school football stadiums that sell out three nights a week.
Oh, where was the Friday Night Lights movie filmed? I think it was. I don't think it was Ohio.
I think it was
Ohio.
A south suburb of Cincinnati,
wasn't
it?
Been, yeah. There was definitely gunshots going off, so it had to be.
We have pretty good football. All right.
You can't say.
But here's the problem. If you ask people in Menominee how their high school football is, like, it's pretty good.
Yeah, it's pretty good. Yeah, it's pretty good.
That's the
Division
5. I've seen that.
Division 5, back to back, 6-7.
Listen, though. Single wing, they did a great job. What I need out of these, like, local high schools here are better mascots. Like,
absolutely.
Who is your mascot?
Freaking Marines.
I had an eagle.
So
okay, that's actually not terrible.
You're like, what even is the mascot for the Maroons or the Marines?
Do you want the Maroons? Do you want to know the Maroons?
Yeah,
we think it's a color, right?
Yeah.
But
The color And here's something for everybody out there who wants to put on their social justice warrior cap.
Great.
So actually, the old mascot for the Menominee Maroons was like an escaped Native American slave.
Of course.
And the color maroon comes from the Spanish word cimarron, which roughly translates to wandering cattle, because that's what they would call the escaped African slaves who would then go roam the hills. They called them cimarrons, like wandering livestock. And then they would go to these communities of natives and sort of mix with them. So if you mix the people that they referred to as red with the people that they referred to as black or brown, what color do you get in the middle of red and brown? You get maroon. And that's where that comes
and
from.
And that's how they named their high school mascot.
Well, a lot of Native Americans
people
in
the area. So there.
I was going to say, let's go cancel the podcast right now.
We'll cancel it.
Yeah, but spend a little time taking the pulse of the locals around here. If you told them that it had that type of a background, they'd be like, why isn't that on the jersey?
Yeah.
we need a better picture of that. We just got the fucking white random color.
Yeah.
Why aren't we embracing this shit?
But, okay.
I don't know why I make them Southern when I go racist, because they're not, but like, they exist everywhere.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah. People are awful.
Quentin, what was yours? Oh, sorry.
What?
What was your high school mascot?
Crusader.
That's
so a knight.
Was it a Catholic school?
Yeah.
Yeah. No, the Crusades were definitely pretty on the up and up as far as it comes to minority groups.
Yeah. Just high class, you know, organization going on there.
Yeah.
Not to find us any better. We were the Vikings, so you know.
We had the Cavaliers to start with, through. And then we got shifted to the Chargers.
Really?
Which
you just
they
take
they
names
deemed,
from professional
well,
teams?
Well, no, it was weird because they determined that the Charger was a horse.
Yeah.
Which in reality it is, but like when you think of the Chargers, you do not think of, as a mascot, you don't think of horses.
I think of a lightning bolt.
Exactly. Yeah. Right.
Whatever the hell that
that's
is.
That's a football team made to do that, but yeah.
Yeah, but like it's just not the first thing that comes to your brain. And then the mascot that they drew, like the photo, the picture was terrible. Like before we switched, the Cavalier that we had on our like the chairs that were the bench at basketball, like the seat had the picture of our Cavalier, but it didn't exist anywhere else within like
the brand.
Do you
know this so well because you sat there very often?
So I love the idea that
that is cold.
I like the idea that, you know, the Chargers, ooh, we think of a lightning bolt and it's actually a horse. I like the idea that your Cavaliers was actually just a depiction of a shitty Chevy. Local dealership sponsored us for a year.
Exactly. Very odd shark-shaped car.
once they discontinued it, we had to change
the name.
No, but it was like this, like a very aggressive-looking pirate. Like he
aggressive.
He didn't at all look...
it's very biblical.
What?
Yeah, see,
you went to a Lutheran school?
I don't even know what a Cavalier would be.
No, I mean it was a pirate, and he had like a swashbuckling dude, and he had like this very big beard. Oh, yeah. He looked like Blackbeard. He was very aggressive. Like had a knife, had a sword out, and everything was like. Cool. I was like, dude, let's put that on the wall. That looks pretty awesome, right?
Yeah.
They never did. I don't know why. It just went on the chairs, and that was it. But then they changed the Chargers, and then painted this big mural on the wall. It was like a circle with this weird outline of a horse head, like in. Face on view with like this, it almost looked like a Harry Potter lightning bolt on it. It's like, why did we do that? Why did we just merge the two?
You know, of a horse looking straight on.
What was the justification for the change?
They put it up to a vote because they thought that the Cavaliers was too old and it had the wrong connotation to it.
Like the connotation of like
boy right
fierce.
Here.
Well, that's what it should have been.
Yeah,
but
listen, hey guys, we need to tone down the mascot a little bit.
Yeah.
It's a little too fighty.
It was weird. It was weird.
Yeah.
Anyways, we got digressed very far.
Pandas take on the Care Bears.
You're rolling today.
Really beating the shit out of each other out there. I didn't.
There's blood all over the fur.
I didn't know that the Montpelier kittens had this kind of fight in them.
Not the fur.
The Labradoodles from South State have really sharpened their elbows for this one.
I think I've asked you this before. You played sports in high school, right?
I did.
What did you play?
Baseball, soccer, basketball. Yeah.
No football?
I was also... No, we didn't have football.
Too small.
Too small.
Oh, really?
We didn't co-op with anybody either.
No, maybe 7-on-7
wasn't a thing yet.
No.
Sprint football?
No, we didn't have any of that.
My school was so small, we had to co-op with like one or two other schools in order to have a football team.
Really?
Yeah, but I was a public school. those Amish, man. They just don't bring them in like they used to.
Everyone's trying to run spread. The Amish still trying 3 yards in a cloud of dust. It just wasn't keeping up.
I'll tell you what, the Amish are fucking good at baseball, though. What's the, what do they speak? Really?
What?
They are.
Do they speak English?
First of all, Petsway's a Dutch.
Dutch. They speak Dutch.
Yeah. Is the correct terminology, right?
Yeah.
What?
The politically correct terminology.
Pennsylvania Dutch?
Yeah.
I mean, no.
As opposed to Amish.
So
I just have never played baseball with any Amish. I mean, I'm a girl, so they probably wouldn't even talk to me.
I remember getting on a team once, and it was like the first game we ever played together, and it was probably 15 people. 14 of them spoke Dutch, and I had no idea what they were saying. I thought they were like, you think they're talking so fast that they're mumbling. So half the game went by, and I was like, man, these guys talk fast. And then finally I was like, what the fuck are you guys saying?
That's because it's Pennsylvania Dutch. Like, there's English words mixed in there.
It's like Spanglish, but worse.
Yeah.
So do the Amish play with, do they play with like old school baseball rules? Like, there's no ground rule double. You can bounce a home run.
No, we were talking about this. Like, did Polish you ever play?
Question.
No, that, when Babe Ruth played, you could still bounce home runs. That's why he wasn't real.
We talked about this once before, I think. Did you ever play vintage baseball? Like, I played vintage baseball against some teams in Ohio, but like, we had old, we had Civil War rules. Well, Civil War rules, like, you could, you were allowed to steal bases, but like regular vintage rules, like no stealing bases, you can catch the out or catch the ball in a bounce and that's an out.
Oh yeah, that the original baseball.
Yeah, there were no
minorities.
No
Knickerbockers.
But that's not what you're talking about. That's not where you played ball with these Amish dudes.
No, they played legit baseball. And they were good.
Low-hanging fruit.
I will say, baseball is the only sport where you can show up and look at everybody and be like, these guys suck. And then they're fucking good.
Look at
like
look
basketball,
at
you show up, you're like, oh, this guy's probably good. Football, you show up, like, oh, this guy's probably
big,
good.
They're probably
I feel like
good.
Darts is another one you can't really judge a book by its cover.
You ever bowling? Darts?
Quentin got to look at his eye. He's like, those are fighting words. That's not a sport.
Literally. A darts crowd would kick the shit out of a baseball crowd any day of the week.
Especially
dart ball.
Ooh. Yeah, dart ball.
How is a ball going to stick to a dartboard?
I know.
If I say the name Michael Van Gerwen, does it mean anything to you?
I just say, bless you, because I thought he sneezed.
He's the goat if you're into the darting world.
The darting world.
So nobody else. Do you know what it is?
Tristan? Look him up sometimes.
Tristan, good morning. Welcome to the podcast.
Yeah, good to see you, Q.
Oh, you're awake now.
I said
I won't talk cricket. I normally get into that when we
talk. Cricket with you. Did you get to that podcast?
Nope.
Talked about cricket for like an hour. He had a cricket blog.
I used to be the number one American cricket blogger in Ukraine.
He was.
In Ukraine.
I had massive number. Numbies in Ukraine.
That took me on a little trip to like get to where that was going. But
it's a self-declared title and I'm going to keep it until someone comes for it.
Right.
I don't think anyone's coming for it.
Ukraine's got other shit going on.
Hope somebody comes for it.
I should revive it. And I'm still doing numbers in Ukraine. It's like,
must be a thing.
Priorities, guys.
Must be a thing.
Like, I wait every day.
All 12.
Yeah, I haven't done it in 2 years.
I've been waiting the return of the Ukraine cricket blogger.
It's like 30, 40 page views from Ukraine every time I post a cricket blog.
Who knew?
I'm going to hire you one day.
When there's no competition.
Yeah, it's not a saturated market.
A lot of records.
Blocked on many Twitter accounts by several cricketers. It's a whole thing.
Oh my gosh.
Just one, mainly. Yeah. But he's like the highest paid in the world. And I just decided one day I was going to not like him before I knew anything about cricket. And then I found out he's kind of a piece of shit and he's kind of really good.
Oh, okay.
At least it was founded.
Yeah, no, it worked out. But I am.
You just lost another viewer.
Yeah.
That's that guy.
Yeah. Yeah. So I'm not listening anymore.
We lost the cricket asshole and the mean girl from Canada.
Oh, so, honestly, we're bad at 500.
Both okay losses.
Good.
I think we should be okay with that.
Yeah,
it should be 1,000.
50% of our views.
Sounds all right.
Just dropping market share. Yeah. Anyway, you were trying to engage Tristan. Tristan, how you doing down there?
Great talking to you.
This is odd. It's weird to see you without a beverage.
What?
Yeah, I was going to say, what's in there?
You got one? Okay.
A little bit of ghost energy drink left. But Q, how are you feeling about playing some video games after this still?
I'm feeling pretty excited. Thanks for reminding me because now I can't sit still.
Dude, here's the
thing. So you're just going to chug like an energy drink, a liquid death, if you will.
I quit energy drinks.
Not an energy drink,
by the way. Right before
you
start and right before bed.
So
Yes.
So can we talk about the fact that we performed fairly well yesterday when we played? And like,
Yeah. He's not going to be able to replicate that.
Ooh. I mean, I don't think he was the reason behind why we won in either situation.
No, no. In fact, he was out of most of it. So, like, when he tries to play without you, this, how's it going to go?
The podcast name is not changing.
No, like, I'm keeping it there. Yeah. I'm putting it there.
It's,
but I forgot it.
National,
I
like it's not of National. Of forget National Women's Day. Yeah. It's National Shit on Quitter Day.
I shall declare today National Shit on Quitter Day.
For the record, I did forget about it. I do apologize to women
from
everywhere.
From now
on, from step aside, ladies. That's right. Quentin.
Quentin's in town.
Quentin.
Yeah.
Quentin, did you do anything to celebrate National Women's Day today?
I didn't know. I just went through a bunch of Snapchat stories about it.
What about you?
Yeah,
did anybody do anything?
I don't know that I did.
Oh, I'm supposed to?
I personally did not do anything for myself.
What's the one do to celebrate
we
that day
you
in the first place?
I bought you a
life
softener.
Go hug your mom. Go hug your mom. I feel like that's a good one.
I text my grandma back for the first time in 3 days, so there's that.
Paul and I throw no judgment on that, though, because we tell people every time when we like make new friends, we're like, we need 3 to 5 business days to respond to texts, so like just know that in
at
our friendships.
At any point in time, we have anywhere from like 10 to 30 unread messages.
Do you have your phone on you?
That's see, awesome. So my problem is I can't stand having the notification, so
eight.
I read it.
Yep.
And then I don't reply.
Just read it. You like, forget about it.
I'm there. My thumbs are on it. All I could do is be like, yep, cool. Nope, can't be bothered.
Current status, 3 phone notifications, 13 message notifications.
Yeah, like this is, that's, honestly,
that's
this,
a light
is,
day.
This
have
is
you,
good for us.
Have
that's
you guys
a light
like that?
This is a sick
well,
brag.
So, no, actually.
Like, when you guys were long distance, were you
no.
on your phone a lot more?
Well, he's like the one person
distance,
I'll pick up for.
I was on the ship, so nothing worked.
That's true.
So I didn't have notifications.
Yeah.
You're right.
But yes, we've always kind of been not great at texting. Mm. We're pretty like low maintenance.
Yeah.
Humans.
We're better face
human
to face.
That's good though.
Yeah.
I'm jealous.
We hope.
We hope. Some people might not like us.
Practicing every day.
Practicing? What are we practicing?
Face to face.
Speaking of phones.
No. Whatever ad read you're about to do.
No, I was just gonna give credit. You know, to divert from shit on Quentin to shit on another regular and wait for it to come back around on me. Tristan hasn't looked at his phone.
Yeah.
Any of the times I've been looking over there.
Yeah. Oh, is this a thing?
Oh.
There was like one or, there was like
was
one or two episodes. One or two episodes where I was on my phone pretty consistently.
We had to start putting this camera over his shoulder.
Yeah. We were going to do that.
So
I wanted to do it where it was set up where anytime he was on his phone, it had to be screen recording and then we would put it in the podcast. But
okay,
I stopped real quick.
That would be hilarious.
Real quick.
But then we came up with an idea that he's probably just looking through the photos of his pugs that he has at home.
Oh, yeah. That was like
that's
conspiracy. Theory about it.
Your pugs?
Yeah, that's what I have for pets.
Little devil's dogs.
Okay.
Yes, pugs. I have fake cats.
See, that's not an ideal dog. From that conversation earlier.
No.
I hate to say
also,
that I have to agree. Not an
we
ideal
need,
dog.
Like, we're too big. Like we need like an unsquishable dog.
Yeah.
Well, pugs kind of look pre-squished.
So my dad
already.
Squished at the front. So my dad used to call. Well, he didn't. Never let us have a dog in the first place. But that's a different story.
Poor kid.
But no, he would call the little small yapper type dogs. I think pugs would probably be included in this.
Yes.
He'd call them punters.
Ooh.
Yes, they are punters.
Because like on accident, you might
very
just
good Michigan dad.
Drop kick. Oh, God, so, here we go. All right, see you later.
That's it. True.
Right.
So
my,
true.
My brother and I have this running thing where we'll everybody thinks he's a lot nicer than I am. He's not. He's just quieter. So we have this running thing
stealthy.
Where we'll just whisper terrible things to each other in public. And one of the running ones is like anytime there's a small dog or a toddler around, he'll just lean and he'll be like, how many yards do you think you're good from with that?
The question is it teed up or not?
I think it's implied. I think it's a place kick at that
enough.
Point. He's like, I'm good from about 35, no wind with that one.
Did he nail it?
He did not kick the 2-year-old. I'm sorry.
Well, thank goodness.
Well, you gotta do it, dude. 100%.
Might result
in like
telling
he gets
you never
one
know.
Baby.
Yeah, until you go to jail? Yeah, probably.
Yeah,
well, yeah, you get one shot, then you're done. That's it.
You're not a better volume shooter with infants.
You better fucking get it.
It's one and done.
The parent's like, dude, fuck yeah, nice shot, man.
Dad's.
Yeah,
that would definitely be a dad response.
Dad.
Yeah.
You know, I'm 100% going to say that about my own.
I was going to catch him.
Yeah.
I was playing punt returner, man.
Yeah.
He loves it. Look, he's laughing.
Oh, my God.
I'm going to whisper to my son to you when he's 2 years old. I could kick you so fucking hard.
He keeps running back.
He likes it.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
Yeah. Yeah, you can kick me now.
No, 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 it's okay. It's okay. Yeah,
you can kick me now.
Okay. We're gonna get ice cream on the way home. I promise not to tell mom.
Ah, parent stuff. You guys want to have kids?
That was the way to kill a mood.
Yeah. Fuck this guy.
Where are you guys planning to have kids?
Well, are you? Do you want to have kids?
Or are you part of that party that just doesn't want to have them?
So we're part of the party that cannot physically have them.
Yeah.
Not to drop a bomb. No problem. It's all good.
Silence and
serious. Yeah,
new
silence. You could have lied, but
that's
okay.
Real awkward here. Just
could have lied.
Just like jumped up on the podcast. Make it better.
Have you ever thought of adopting or no?
I mean, absolutely.
We're going to try to like medically have our own little test tube baby. We're going to
rock the science first, you know.
Fuck yeah, dude.
Listen, I married up. I need to tap into those brains like legit and then like do that in the offspring. So, that's the whole, the whole ball game.
Married up?
You're taller than me, so yes.
Wow, okay. Oh. Physically up, that's okay.
It's very primal.
Wow.
Yeah.
All right.
That's like caveman. Well, you're taller than me, so I'm going to marry you.
Actually,
we talked about this on a previous one. There is a theory out there that human population is going to bisect into tall, smart people and short, dumb people.
I think it is.
We listened to that podcast that told us, like, did you know that this area was like notorious for like really not smart people for a really long time?
This
and
area?
It was
it ended?
Yeah. Because of iodine. Like it was a goiter like deficiency and things like that. And it was like a self-perpetuating thing where like nobody was getting enough salt, nobody believed iodine. And then nobody believed in anything that anyone was telling them. And so like until they like started iodizing salt that like fixed the problem nationally. Yeah, like up here, it was like known for like less smart people. Hmm. Not shitting on the locals here. I'm so sorry.
No,
this
was like,
a while ago.
How long?
Yeah, we,
what Detroit, is the systemic problem?
Yeah, I believe the Detroit Free Press puts out average standardized test scores every year, and it's not
it's
old
below.
News.
Yeah.
It's tough. It's a tough look.
Yikes.
Gosh.
Yeah, no.
Yeah.
I learned that the hard way when I got to college that this is what we call a small pond.
Yeah.
Yikes.
Yeah.
Wait, where'd you go?
Michigan.
Okay.
That's why it's easy for me to shit on Ohio.
Yeah, you had to drive
it's natural.
It.
You
I have,
right?
I have to.
Yeah,
you
into his veins.
Listen,
what a giver.
If tomorrow I contracted a rare disease and the only cure was at The Ohio State University, it would be a coin toss. Like, that's where I'm programmed at this point. I didn't graduate from Michigan, so I could maybe have a little leeway. But
yeah, they'd let you in.
Yeah.
It would work both ways. Still, you have to, like, mutually agree upon it.
I'd be like, I don't have a Michigan diploma. Will you guys treat me?
Yeah. That feels
yeah, accurate. And then they would still be like,
And you're up in Marquette?
No, I'm from like 20 minutes north of here.
No, where'd you go to school, my friend?
In Houghton.
Houghton?
Yeah, it's in the top of
Houghton.
Okay,
Houghton.
Okay.
Just about there to Canada there.
Yeah,
about
pretty damn close.
And yet you've still never been
hence
to Canada.
My accent.
Yeah,
it's the snowiest place in the lower 48. They really like to get out there, rip
probably
her on the sleds a little bit.
Probably.
I think I said Marinette, but I definitely meant Marquette.
It's a little bit more north of Marquette.
More north?
Yeah, an hour and a half north of Marquette.
No, it's real nice in the winter. You just shovel a little path out there. You tuck
every
a cart 30
day
rack in the snow. You don't even have to put them in the freezer. It's nice.
That's called outdoor fridge right there.
Fridge. You
we
set
have
up
that
a little
in Pennsylvania
fire.
Too. Yeah, outdoor fridge.
Carve a little fire pit out in the snow. Sit there with the boys.
The
a couple.
The amount of 2 liter bottles of soda.
But my family's
and
garage.
Juice. And leftovers and any number of things
like
that exist in her family's garage.
The outdoor garage.
The outdoor fridge.
And
then
you have to clean up, at least one busted 2 liter per
at least.
Year.
Yeah.
Because it just freezes inevitably and then everything is all over the floor and it's a sticky mess.
Yeah,
it's not
so
great.
There's another regional one in there and I'm curious.
I'm ready.
In your bartending times.
Oh yeah.
Here. Has anyone gotten real uppity about pop versus soda?
Oh.
No, nobody
okay.
slams
so
me for
Chicago,
that.
That was a big thing.
Is Chicago a soda town?
It was a pop town.
Okay. Yeah.
Always
so when I went downstate, and I use them somewhat interchangeably.
Yeah, I think
but
I do
it
too.
Is, but
I mostly
if you do
say
a soda,
soda,
like, you mean pop?
Yep.
You
mean, like pop. It's just like in the South. Yeah. It was like, no, it's a Coke. It's
yeah,
like,
I was going to say
clearly that's a fucking Dr. Pepper. Like, no, it's a fucking Coke.
What kind of Coke
well,
you
this
want?
This is a family-friendly show. Watch
it.
Not
what I listen to.
Not at all. Not at all.
She's
like, whoa. Only the first 15 seconds.
It's not family-friendly. It's not family-friendly. We don't stop there.
That's right. Might as well just push right on through.
Yeah. True. True.
Are you a pop or soda?
I'm definitely soda.
Yeah, I actually, I'm soda too.
I think that's
I think pop is a little odd. The world.
So
we are like basically neighbors.
I just feel like pop is like a kids thing.
So
or
so
it makes pop. Pop.
I feel the same way.
When they go back to my hometown, I guarantee you, if you say pop. Soda, they're gonna go, "Oh, you ain't from around here."
Yeah. Yeah, that known Chicago drawl.
Oh yeah. Oh, you ain't from around here.
My grandma is like very inclusive. She calls it soda pop. So
yeah, it's, see, yeah. When people get real uppity about it's pop, I'm like, all right, I'll have a soda pop, soda please. Pop.
Yeah.
It's weird that they call it Coke, everyone down south, because it's actually all cola, right?
Well,
it's like Pepsi Cola, Coca Cola.
Well, if you're talking about cola in general, or RC Cola, right?
Yeah, when someone drops
absolutely.
What kind of Coke you want? I'll have a Sprite.
Yeah,
then breaks your brain.
Yeah, exactly.
What is considered a cola?
Like the dark
brown,
with like syrup kind of sugar.
Like, like Coke, like Pepsi,
Coca Cola,
RC,
like Coca Cola is root like the cola portion is the generic term.
I feel like they would rather you ask for like a Sprite or a root beer than ask for unsweet tea, though. I feel like you're just looking to get your tires slashed. If you were just like, I'll take that unsweet tea, that'd be like, I'll pray for you.
What planet have you come from?
Yeah,
you said,
if you said, I'll have a tea and they brought it, you're like, ooh, this is sweet.
That's even better.
No, that's honey baby child, that's tea.
That's right.
I don't know what you're talking about. That's how we make it around here.
That's right.
Mama sweet tea.
Yeah.
So on the regional ones, I'll hit this one. And for everybody but maybe Tristan, if someone talks about a bubbler.
Yep. Water fountain.
We had to learn.
Okay.
Yeah. Oh, my favorite thing?
I grew up knowing the bubbler because we frequently came to Wisconsin.
I was going to say, because there's a weird band, and actually it's Kohler called their first one the Magic Bubbling Fountain, which became a bubbler, and that's why we get it here.
Correct.
But yeah, outside of this area, that is...
Nope. Drinking fountain, water fountain, anything outside of this region.
And there's people who get weird about that one.
Yep.
Yeah.
Are you guys supper or dinner type of people?
Dinner. I don't think I ever said supper in a real sentence.
I don't think I might be
never even heard of supper.
No, yeah, I've never heard of her. No, I don't think I...
Supper,
I think I would mostly say dinner.
We prefer to go with dipper.
Dipper.
More of a lupper guy. I like throw in the middle.
I feel like supper is for old people at 4 o'clock in the afternoon.
Yeah, it's at like midtime. I kind of get great.
Like
my grandparents.
Yeah.
You know what my favorite one around here is?
The supper club.
No, we talked about this the other day. Fun. I borrowed it to you.
Oh yeah.
People say all the time.
It's
like,
the worst.
Oh, I borrowed that to somebody else.
I borrowed my bike to somebody.
It's didn't.
No.
That borrowed my bike.
Let that
ruminate for a second there.
Let that marinate there.
Yeah. Just let that marinate there. But
any Letterkenny friends
out there? Yeah. You got a problem with Canada Gooses? You got a problem with me? But suggest all that marinate.
Whoa. Something just came out there.
Have you ever watched Letterkenny?
No, you guys told me to. It's on the list.
You need to.
Yeah, I'm gonna need to take about 5-10 off.
That's my dip.
Right now,
good news. Oh, not so bad.
My favorite Squirrely Dan one is when he just finally yells, "Wayne, your sister's hot," and he takes off in the field. Where are you going, Squirrely Dan? I'm tired.
Have you seen
it? Yeah, that show has some amazing lines from it.
Yeah, we agree. So
I like the one where they talk about the emo guys and they say like they paint their nails black and write poetry all day.
That's right.
I
don't know if you guys remember that. That's exactly right.
Skins.
Really funny.
Shirt tuckers.
Really
funny. Shirt tuckers.
Jimmy Dix
got some great lines.
Oh, Jimmy Dix.
All
right, now.
There's a Dickinson in engineering.
Oh, no.
And I can't.
Every day. And it's.
It doesn't help that it's electrical, so I just automatically want to shit on it. So it's like Dickskin up there doing his electrical shit.
So. Full disclosure, we did have to turn subtitles on for the first couple episodes to actually 100%. Understand what they were saying.
Also, I just enjoy subtiles because
I'm a subtitle watcher myself with every show.
So it sounds like tonight after this, before you start your gaming session, we've got to watch the first episode of Letterkenny.
No, you probably should watch it.
Okay. He works banker's hours.
Who the fuck cares?
He doesn't show up to work until lunch anyway. So
fucking codes internet websites while he's there.
Just like damn Skippy.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
Damn Skippy. He's over there with his freaking camera and his photo booth taking shots of fucking crops and whips.
He's
got busy office. He's not hitching hard tomorrow.
Jordan turns around and goes, "What the fuck is that?"
It's funny that you think Jordan's
there. Oh, it's for baseball.
Oh no.
Yeah.
Jordan's never there.
Yeah, I know.
Where did Miguel go?
Back home? That's a good question.
That's a good question. Yeah. Yeah.
He came in here for like a second, and I feel like he left.
He was going to hang out before we started, and then that he came in, saw we started.
My bad.
That's right. So he did get an apartment here finally.
Oh, did he?
Yeah, he was trying to, and then basically they said that no, TMMG has taken all the apartments in the building, so you can't have one.
I'm proud.
He actually came to me to see. He came to me to see if we could sublet him one, and we had literally zero room at the time. And I was like, dude, I'm really sorry. I totally would, but I don't know what to tell you.
Quinton was going to charge him like $800 a month for the other room.
$200? Going to give him a good deal.
So you could have jacked it way the hell
hustle,
up.
Bro. Yeah. Hustle, bro. Hustle. That's all it is. So you got two bedrooms in here, man.
Yeah, if I could tolerate that much human interaction, I have an empty room. But there's no amount of money.
There's a limit. Yeah.
That's fair. We've had roommates a lot before, and we've just decided, like, yeah, we're done.
We're cooking with headlamps right now. Are you kidding me?
I understand that. I understand that. We've had a lot of roommates.
Rent's real cheap at the Stikes household. We've had a lot
of roommates as a couple.
Yes,
and we've had enough of that.
We have. Lots of roommates.
No more of that. Like the bear and stuff out there.
We had the Walmart people. We had a little fox come up one time.
Oh, yeah.
He was our roommate.
That was the Skagway.
Gave him a spell bedroom.
Yeah, in our... pop-up camper
in our 26 square foot camper.
So
what does the fox say?
Dead, we leave it there.
How did that just pop in your head? That's from like 2014.
Oh yeah, something so like long ago. Jeez. Yeah.
Before we go,
that's 10
years ago.
I graduated college in 2014. Don't do that to me.
Okay, we'll change the subject. So out of all the places you guys have been, which was your guys' favorite? Or which one you guys would want to live in for the rest of your life? If you had to pick one.
The rest of our life.
Now you're skipping.
I feel like those two answers are separate.
All right. We'll give us them both.
Yeah.
All right. We'll say it. One, two.
No. I don't know what you're going to say.
Try it.
That's the point.
Yeah. So which one are we answering first?
We'll answer where would we go back? Was that the first one?
Yeah. Like which place would you rather... Like what's your favorite place to spend like a vacation? And like which place would you rather spend a... your life.
Okay, I'm not gonna say life. Which one would we live in next? Ready? 1, 2, 3. Alaska.
I
was gonna say Alaska.
I was still deciding between two at the time.
He was like, Alaska.
Well, it was either gonna be Baja or it was gonna be Greece, but I remember you hadn't been to Greece, so I was like, I can't say that.
Can you feel that burn? Can you feel that burn? Yeah.
You did that on purpose.
Yeah.
So my favorite place is the one that I went without you.
Perfect.
While you were freezing in camping in parking lots.
We were homeless, struggling to survive in Alaska. Right. Yeah. I was living it up.
I would go back to live in Alaska for a few years.
I would agree
for sure.
I thought that place would just isolate.
It's okay. Just let it be. He was very confident as he said it.
That's like when you take a supplement. It's the way isolate.
Yeah.
It's just isolated.
I thought you use the word same way.
But what's the thing though? You're not allowed to pick on someone if they pronounce a word wrong because it means they learned it by reading.
By what?
Yeah, I know. We'll work a groaner in there. That's okay.
That's all right. You gotta work a groaner in.
That is evident of how that last joke landed.
Paul, where would you live forever?
Oh, Montana.
Also really fast.
That's it. Montana loves Montana.
Montana was super great. Actually, we drove.
We just can't afford it.
We drove through Walmart. Whitefish. We drove through Whitefish, Montana, and I was like, I don't know what I like. Like how many organs I have to sell to live here, but it might be worth it.
Yep.
So it was, it was pretty cool.
Whitefish was really awesome. That whole area up there was really awesome.
But not like in Whitefish because that was like bougie white people.
It was bougie, yeah. But, it was almost like ski lodge town, but like hadn't been to like steamboat level yet. It was still just bougie, but like the real rich people.
But like outside like the of fake Whitefish, rich people on
steamboat, right?
I know what you're feeling. Yeah.
They're ahead of the curve.
Yeah, we've had that conversation around here. Like, what's rich? And it's like, ooh, I drive a Cadillac. It's like, you wouldn't be allowed. Like, your community has gates. Ours has a moat, that type of thing.
A moat with a standing militia.
Yeah,
gators.
Yeah,
jeez. You got gators in that bitch.
Yeah, exactly.
Where are you guys? Where do you guys want to live? Are you moving to South Carolina anytime soon?
Yeah, I was going to say, the pressure got put on pretty hard there when they paid for your
trip. That's a full court press.
Right? I'm just kidding.
I don't know if they necessarily paid for my trip.
I'm just kidding. That was just based off the previous podcast episode.
Shit, did we say something like that?
No, because it was acceptable gifts.
Wait, what?
What are you talking about?
Whoa, you're trying to get us into more trouble than we had to be in.
Wait, what happened?
You know, I remember that trip. And that was, I'd met Quinton like twice. I've only gotten to know Tristan through this.
Oh, man.
So I'm sitting there and Quinton showed up with another gentleman at the time and sort of that rotation. And mm-hmm. Tristan got first pick in the draft. And I'm sitting there. I'm like, fucking Tristan's out on road trips hanging out with the guys and I'm sitting here watching this guy make fucking paper airplanes. You kidding me right now?
Wait, yeah, like, give me the initial.
Nope.
Yeah,
that's right.
No, I just remember walking in that Monday. I'm like, motherfuckers.
Oh,
yeah.
I know you're talking.
Just to be clear, it wasn't my call.
Yeah, no, I knew that. And
again,
I
was also very TMMG as like a collective.
I was also very fresh at the time. So
I'm sitting there fresh. And I remember when I knew he was at, and I'm like, I'm gonna have to, it's not technically my call, but like, I'd like to be in the room when we talk about who's coming up here next. Cause like,
damn, I wish we were this close back then. Cause you could have came down, bro. We had a hell of a time. Yeah. Like, you showed up 24 hours late.
Fucking figured that out later.
24 hours. Oh yeah, that's right.
Yeah. Yeah,
about that.
Yeah, I forgot about
that. My favorite excuse that y'all like give, like we're not stupid and only a couple years older. I missed my flight. That is like,
dude.
Yeah,
we actually did.
No, I missed my flight. I was so fucking hammered. Pissed off.
Exactly.
I missed my flight.
Exactly. Yeah. I know better. That's all I'm trying to say.
We know.
Kids who
there's
don't
no way. It's like, traffic. There was a train. It's nah, bro, you were hammered.
I was 3 hours after we were supposed to leave.
When are you coming
in? I'm waiting for the time when
I was thinking like July.
Oh, for.
That'll be a good time here.
How far are you from?
Bro,
how far are you
visit,
from? Like,
if I'm not moving,
like DC.
Ooh, that's
a
like
good
a
bit.
It's like 10 hours.
See,
yeah.
See to me, like that's all the same part. So like,
well, it's all the same general region,
it's
right?
All
let me take you to DC and then let me take you to Charleston. And we'll see. If it's
you go from like Richmond north, and it's like consistent city.
Yeah. So I'm just
trying. You guys should. Yeah.
No, I'm trying to figure out how I could parlay my next work trip into swinging through there. But if it's not as close,
it's not as close as what you think.
It wasn't. And also, I pretend that we have a travel policy that would allow that.
You're taking the Gulfstream, huh?
Yeah. No, I'm
FMM Gulfstream.
Yeah, I'm gonna hop on the Fincanti jet and just fly on over there.
No, it's it's referred to the family jet.
It was really all his idea. You weren't even supposed to come with him.
We get over there and got nice stuff. But
yeah. Yeah,
it was 100% Luke's fault, by the way. You can have to watch this, even though you're probably not.
It wasn't them taking me, Brock. It was originally just supposed to be me and Luke. I was just supposed to help him be moving, but then Quinton.
Because, okay, let's just throw
Quinton
it all
attached
out.
Tristan, himself like a leech, is that what
Tristan
you're saying?
Tristan was supposed to be moved to Charleston by now.
You're going to have to edit the shit out of this. This
Do you know how many times
wanted
to go anyway?
So he was going to drive down with Luke to Charleston to see it.
Yeah.
And then Luke didn't have to drive 18 hours by himself.
Okay.
And then I was like, because the flight was super fucking expensive. And you paid full for the flight.
Yeah.
It's like $500 to get back.
No, not that much. $400.
Oh,
as,
not that,
as
not
he
that.
Laughs
and
at you. And
so then I was
and
like,
why did you get discounted for it again?
Because I was on Concur. And I was like,
oh,
let me check Concur.
That's right. Yeah.
And then I was like, it's $120 if I just like buy it this way. So then I was like, all right, fuck it, I'm going. And then it was that night.
Thanks for that, bro. Thanks.
Saturday. What did you have? You already fucking bought it.
So who rode in the back seat? That's the real question.
Tristan slept the whole goddamn time.
I just slept tracks. Sideways back there.
Yep. We went to Bucky's. Once we hit Bucky's, that kid was out.
What?
Was Bucky's, before though. That shit.
You didn't experience a Bucky's?
Did you get, some Did you get some go from Everbilia?
No. That stuff was everywhere in there.
Everywhere.
That place was crazy.
But the bathrooms. Quality
when I went in there was a guy pissing on the floor, missing the urinal.
Just
that's
because
he's just
the only guy that was in there.
That's
was
just
pissing
he's
on
a dick.
The floor straight up.
And they actually cleaned up before you left.
No, it wasn't.
He blinked.
As he was pissing, the guy was mopping.
I know. Double.
He's like, you done yet?
Okay. Really pissing on the floor.
I'm pissing on the floor, and it still is clean in here.
Yeah, that's right.
You should come down though. You guys should come down together.
I'm planning on my perspective on that trip.
I was just thinking. I was like, I wish you guys come down, but. If you can't, come down.
Yeah. So my perspective on that
we're
trip at the time, I'm sitting
we're
there
too
going,
old for the
you're
cool
too
kids.
Busy.
Yeah, no, we're, we're too old for the cool kids.
You're
that's
too
exactly
important,
what it's
Paul.
No,
fuck
that's no, that was the standpoint I was taking. I don't think you'd ever get more than 2 days off. Especially since you just took your vacation.
We'll be in Virginia Beach like
do you think that's all of my vacation? I was gone for a week.
Hey, you need to talk it up. Let's go. Come down to Charleston. You're going to come back 24 hours late. Let me tell you.
Let's go.
Yeah.
No,
hey. It would be fun. You can tell that lie to Steve, too, and he's going to know exactly what that means also.
Oh, I know.
He wrote the book.
He knows exactly what happens.
Yeah.
Nice. He's the one who lives on Spotted Cow and would live at the brewery sucking off a nipple.
King Fireball down there.
That's where it comes from. I just remember that trip because I had a bunch of... I almost didn't use all my vacation before the end of the year. So I'm like,
yeah,
well, that sucks because they're friends. I'm like, I think Trist fucking hates me. I don't know Quentin. I only know Luke from the Nest tapes he sends me, and I'm not a big fan. So I'm like, fuck it. Hope they're having a good time. No, it's cool. I don't like fun. Jeez.
Damn, dude.
No, the weather's great here in December. Why would I want to leave?
Damn, I thought you didn't like us, dude. Fuck yeah, dude. You should come down next week.
I also didn't know you. I didn't know Luke. I barely knew Tristan.
Next week, he's going to be in Italy, right?
Okay, the week after next week.
I got a couple things in Milwaukee.
I'm coming from Penn State.
And then I'm in D.C. So.
Are you in Italy, like, learning things?
Yeah, no, this is a work trip. It's not a vacation.
Fucking moron.
See, you wish it was an Italy trip, not learning things.
Learning different things. Assume.
Sorry.
I'm not going to come back with a lot of knowledge of ancient Rome.
No, or maybe even that much pasta.
Yeah, no, I'm closer. I said I'm closer. That's... The primary yard we're going to is closer to Ukraine than Rome.
Hey, Ukraine's a cool place.
Yeah, it's popping.
literally.
Your foreign travel there is
up. Fire over there.
Must be going well.
Flights are so cheap.
Shit's fire, bro. It's the bomb diggy.
All right.
Oh, boy.
No, okay. So, second week of April.
Second week of April. So I'm going to get back from D.C.
Yeah, worse than mine.
Oh.
What?
Sorry. I thought we were going downhill.
Oh, you have... Oh, that's
so
bomb.
So second week of April. So yeah, I'll get back from DC. I'll pack up. I'll come out.
Yeah,
come on down.
I'm not kidding.
Tristan knows when
me and Luke say we're doing something, we're fucking doing it.
We're just gonna
because we were gonna go to Iceland in March.
That one I was.
We can still do that.
Well, it's March.
It is March.
It's March to March.
Our company had a nice travel policy. I'm flying out of you guys really fucking Netherlands on the way back. I'll just pop up there.
Third week of April. Change of plans. We have another wedding to go to.
You won't be there.
I think we're booked up for the rest of the year, actually. What?
Yeah.
Listen, Quentin.
What?
I have house projects. And homeboy needs to step two.
If you guys ever want to you let me know.
I said what I said.
That's what I said.
So what's your plan?
But you've no excuse.
Hang on now. I also have a home that I have to tend to.
Okay, we're building this home.
And I have cats. Yeah,
someone's
going to
feed the cats that don't exist.
Exactly.
The auto feeder doesn't work anymore.
Did I ever mention an excuse?
No, I'm just waiting. What do you got?
I don't have one. I'll be there.
He's trying to
week April, baby. Let's party.
Trying to time it out with his job interviews down there.
I live at home with my parents.
Back to being pleased at work? Things are just like hunky dory.
For me right now?
Yeah.
Time out now.
No, we won't get into that.
One of the more private, dark little offices up there. But
not what I meant, friends.
Pleased at work.
I'm working on getting a better office.
Yeah, you don't really even have one right now, do you?
Yeah. They're working on remodeling.
Makes you feel any better. I think I'm going to be kicked out of my office.
There's nothing up there right now.
TMMG
guys get to stay on the ground floor.
The bullpen.
I'm just saying, if I come back and I don't have a spot up there, I'm going to be pissed.
Mike doesn't get to go upstairs.
Can I hear you are coming back as a fact?
Well, he's got to come back because the podcast is going to suffer without us.
Yeah, that's
true. And he has to build in his brand with a little bit of exclusivity.
We will see.
I feel like he's going to...
Scarcity.
Want his key.
I hope Steve's not watching this because Steve's going to call me tomorrow and be like, when are you thinking about coming back now? He's really fucking good at that shit.
I know. He's so smooth.
He's going to call me in a week. What's your plans?
Probably not. You'd never forget him.
I think I met Steve once.
Oh, just kidding.
I walked up to Steve...
Very forgettable guy, apparently.
No, I think I met Steve, and I think in the first 2 seconds,
just like, totally forgettable.
Yeah.
Did you ever think about working for someone else?
That sounds about right.
Always trolling.
Yep. Yeah, that's like the line, like, always be selling. That's Steve.
Yeah.
No, it was, are you, he's like, are you happy here? And I gave a blow off political answer. I'm like, yeah, good days. That's not what I asked.
Yeah.
Happy here?
Yeah.
Like, could be happier somewhere else. There's a number on the table. Yeah.
Let's go. Let's throw it out.
It's
bud.
A joke.
How happy would I be somewhere else?
It's a joke unless you don't want it to be a joke.
Yeah. Like, joke till it's not.
Exactly.
We're all just kidding unless you're down.
Yeah, that's right. Unless you're down.
That's right.
Wait, but when are you hoping to hop a ship?
I don't know yet.
Are you ever going to again?
Oh, okay. Okay.
Oh, yeah. Yes.
I don't know if I told you this.
No. Yes. Oh.
So the podcast and YouTube is actually starting to get a lot of traction. So now I'm kind of...
Oh, wait. Like legit?
Yeah.
Yeah. It's actually hopping right now.
There's people that listen and there's a lot of people that are following my channel. So now I'm like, well, if I go home for 3 months and do this full time, I want to see how where it goes. And then if I have 1,000 people and then I just leave, I'm worried that it's going to... I got to start from zero.
So this is where you do the shameless plug of... Hey, we're not going away. We're just going to be back later.
Right.
You bank up some evergreen ones now.
Remind your viewers, right?
Not your
listeners.
You spend those 3 months to record enough evergreen content to still release weekly while you're gone.
Yeah, absolutely. Just have Logan push the post button and you're set to go.
That's one option.
Or I come back up here for 9 days, and
which is probably what you're going to do.
Sailing.
Well, so the other option was it does actually go away for the period that you're sailing, but you hype it up in a way that now people are expecting it and they're waiting with bated breath for when you come back.
I would need like a crowd. Right. Like if I had 50,000 people that subbed to me and I was like, hey, I have to go to work, but I'm going to make a banger video, like never before seen footage on the ship, then I might be like, all right, I'm waiting 3 months for this guy to come back, you know?
100%.
Absolutely.
15 people.
But if you can release like little teasers along the way or stuff to keep people engaged.
Or have like Luke come do like a pop-in one. Have Brock do a pop-in one.
Yeah.
I know what everybody's going to tell me go to see make money. Luke already makes fun of me for it. I know what everybody's going to tell me, but I know what I want to do in 10 years. You know what I mean? So it's like... Be broke for a year.
There's multiple ways of getting there.
Yeah. You know I don't know.
There's multiple ways of getting there.
We still don't have it figured out.
No, I know. I'm not saying we do.
Yeah.
Saying
we do. Check cameras.
I don't know. That's all right. We're at 2 hours.
I was going to say, we got to cut this, I'm sure.
I don't know. I'll figure it out. If I'm broke in the streets, then I'll go to sea.
It's always a good backup plan. But it's also a good primary plan.
Yeah.
For a period, right?
Tristan, you want to close this out?
Oh,
what do you got to say?
What is it like closing work? Prayer?
Usually we just
say. I was going to say,
gather around.
It's in Kumbaya.
It's getting late.
Obviously, there's still some energy here.
But Tristan.
Sun's getting real low.
I find that if I'm feeling a little bit restless, sometimes I like to turn on the Calm app.
Shit.
You're like ominous noises when you're trying to fall asleep? A little bit of a guided meditation, Headspace, promo code Hectic.
Matthew McConaughey in your ear.
In case you're looking for some late night mental stimulation, go to Lumosity.
Lumosity.
I like that one. Keep your brain trained. Learn some new words. You know, keep your brain sharp.
Mental agility. That's what we're going for.
Thanks for having us on.
Yeah, of course.
Thanks for coming.